second forum, 14 candidate forum event this evening here at Jasper Middle School. My name is Jim Freeman. We're live this evening on WLAF La Follette. You'll be able to watch this evening's events on 1450WLAF.com, also at the LaFollettePress.com in a couple of days. We'll have to get all this together and work it out. We appreciate you being here tonight. We decided on a smaller venue. That way it looks like we have a bigger crowd. We probably have about as many as we did a couple of weeks ago, right? Would you say, Karen? Maybe about the same, but we really appreciate you coming out this evening. Our plan was to have the air conditioning turned on Monday, and they said you can't do that. They said, how about Thursday morning? We said we can live with that, and it wound up being about 2 hours ago. So our apologies. We're doing the best we can with that. But Mr. Ruther was trying to take great care of us on that, and it just didn't work out. But we thank Steve Ruther, the principal here at Jasper Middle, for allowing us to come in tonight. And hopefully we won't have anybody pass out this evening because it is a little bit warm. Our panelists this evening, on the left end, is Charles Boomer Winfrey with WLAF, formerly of the La Follette Press. Noah Smith with WLAF and the La Follette Press. Noah is a freshman to be at Campbell High. Rick Shanning is the editor of the La Follette Press. Joe King is with the La Follette Press. He'll be doing our timekeeping tonight. We'll have two-minute intervals for introductions, and then each question will have a two-minute time span for the folks to answer. Karen Kermich is the La Follette Press editor manager, La Follette Press manager. She's on the near end here. And did I spell your name correctly, Karen? C-U-M-O-R-I-C-H? Oh, good. Okay. That's not easy. And Sam Smith is here with us. He's also with the La Follette Press. And as you come up, candidates, and for those of you seated already, there is a Sam Smith business card there in front of you. If you take that up, please, it has Sam's email address on it. He's going to be doing a special section on the election in just a few days. He would like to have a 200, maybe 300-word message from you, your platform, etc. Just email it to Sam, and he will feature you in that publication coming out. Is that next Thursday? Is that right? Or is it going to be a little bit later? Okay, it'll be a week before the 7th, I guess the last of July there. But if you do that timely, we appreciate it, right? Okay, very good. Now, what we will do this evening is start with two-minute introductions. Our school board candidates from District 3 and 4, Virgil Kidwell to your right, my left, Scott Hill, Clint Bain, Ms. Faye Heatherly, and Tim Woods. Tim Woods and Clint Bain are running in District 4. Virgil Kidwell and Scott Hill and Faye Heatherly are in District 3. Scott Hill is the incumbent. District 4 incumbent Eugene Lawson is not here. Maybe yet. He might show up. But we will begin with two-minute introductions. Who will go first this evening, Karen? Okay, very good. Virgil, here you go, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're good.
My name is Virgil Kidwell. I live on West Walden Street, Fallon. I'm the 3rd District. I decided to run for school board because there's a lot of few things that I want to get done. And I think this is just an introduction. When you ask questions, I'll tell you what all they are. I have a real good venue. I used to work in a factory, but not substituting in the school system of a day. I know what's inside and I know what's outside. And I believe we've got a good bunch of people in Campbell County, but I'd like to see a lot of more things done. Thank you.
From Virgil Kibler, we go to incumbent Scott Hill from District 3. Scott.
Thank you. And my name is Scott Hill, and I currently hold one of the two seats in the 3rd District on the Campbell County Board of Education, or the school board. I'm happily married to my wife, Lakin, and lived here, and have lived here in Campbell County for 20-plus years now, and went to middle and high school here in our county. I'm seeking re-election to this seat for one more term, and the reason that I'm seeking re-election is that I feel over the last 4 years, we've made great strides in our system. In that time, we've hired a director of schools who truly cares about the education of our children. Director Poston has assembled a great support staff in his office, and who in turn has helped rally our principals, our teachers, our teachers' aides, our cooks, our custodians, and our maintenance department, and all those involved. And it takes all of those departments to have a successful school system, and those departments working together. And according to our test scores and our graduation rates, and one thing that I've always mentioned is the amount of money that has been awarded to our senior classes at both high schools, Campbell County and Jellicoe, over the last 4 years has just been outstanding. And so that tells me that the system that we are in right now is working. We still have room for growth, and we will never stop seeking ways to continue that growth in our school system. We have made these strides, and we want to continue to do so even further. We have put different programs in place that have saved the school system money, which in turn we have put back into the schools and is being used in various programs in our school. I am proud of the accomplishments that we as a board have made and as a school system have made over the last 4 years, and I hope to continue to be a part of the great things that are coming over the next 4 years. Thank you.
Scott Hill, thank you, Scott. And sometimes we have to draft people around the radio station. And this evening we drafted one of our old buddies, Gary Carter. Gary, thank you for coming out and manning the camera for us this evening. We now go to Clint Bain. Clint is a candidate in District 4. Clint.
Thank you, Jim. I'd first like to thank both the Follett Press and WLAF for the invitation to attend this event tonight. My name is Clint Bain, and I am running for school board within the 4th District. My lovely wife, Monica, who is in attendance tonight, and I have been married for 21 years. We have two children. Our daughter, Brooke, will be a senior this year at Campbell County High School, and our son, Jared, will be a freshman this year at Campbell County High School. I graduated from University of Tennessee in 1990 with a Bachelor of Science degree in Civil Engineering. Education has always been very important to me in my life, even more so now that I have two children in the school system, but not just for my children, but for all the children in Campbell County. I have over 20 years of experience managing budgets up to $500 million a year. These budgets are made up entirely of taxpayer dollars. There are so many doors to be opened out there and so many opportunities for our children if they are able to obtain a very good education. My main objective for running for this office is to work as hard as I can to ensure that the opportunity for the best education is being made available to all of our children. I think that it is vital that our teachers, our parents, and the community have a voice in improving our school systems. So I greatly appreciate your vote and your support. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Clint Bain, candidate for District 4. We now go to Ms. Faye. Faye Hedley, candidate in District 3. Faye?
Well, it is good to be here, and I appreciate the opportunity, and I'm going to make this statement before somebody else says something to me about it. I almost didn't come tonight, and I called Jim because I broke my crown off of my front tooth. So I can't smile real big, but if I don't smile at you and say hello, it's because I'm not going to do that. But my purpose for being here and to run for school board for the 3rd District is that I have the same reason now that I did the 10 years that I served on the board. I have a genuine and a heartfelt and a deep passion for the education in this county. And I feel like that with all of the years experience that I had serving on the board, which was 10 years, we had a lot of extensive training, and I feel like that would go a long way even now, even though there's been changes and new things that we would have to adopt and adapt to. But there are changes in our system, and one of the challenges that I think is facing us, and one of the things that I wanted to be involved in, is I realized that a lot of the monies that we had when I served on the board, like Race to the Top and the stimulus money, that money is used up and gone, to my understanding. But we still need to use every resource that is available to us to make sure that our students, when they leave Campbell County High School, Jellicoe High School, or whichever high school they attend, they need to be prepared for the next level. And for our children to receive a quality and adequate education, that they'll be ready to wherever they decide to go, whether it's in the workforce or whether it's in college or whether it's a homemaker, whatever they decide to do, we need to be responsible for providing them that excellent education and that excellent opportunity. And I have some invested interest because I have 2 grandchildren and 6 great-grandchildren that are in the Campbell County school systems, and not only for them, but for all of their students is why I'm here.
Thank you, Faye Heatherly, candidate for District 3 School Board. Rector Miller and Daryl Chapman, are you able to hear us back there? Good, okay, very good. Let's move on to Tim Woods. Tim is a candidate for school board in District 4. Tim?
Good evening. Thank you for all for coming out. My name is Tim Woods. I live in the Twin Cove community now. I grew up in Pinecrest. I'm married to Cynthia Woods, who's a teacher at Jacksboro Elementary. She teaches kindergarten. I have three children, Clark, Lindsay, and Bo. Clark's 26. Lindsay actually just graduated from Campbell County High School. And Bo is a sophomore. I also have two grandchildren, Jackson and Kendall. Jackson is going to be going into kindergarten at Jacksboro Elementary. My wife and I both went through the school system. A lot of friends of mine, for years we've all been through the school system. It's improved over the years. The administration now, I know, works hard, and the staff, we have great teachers in place. My goal and the reason that I want to be involved in this, I've always done what I could to help kids in the school. I want to continue that, and at this point in my life, I think that doing this is how I can help improve and move forward and prepare for the future. And I appreciate your vote. Thank you.
Thank you. Tim Woods, candidate for school board in District 4. If you're just joining us on the radio, we're talking with the candidates for school board, Districts 3 and Districts 4. Who will ask the first question this evening? Oh, everybody points toward Noah. Okay. You'll be impressed to know that Noah had a lot of questions that he submitted this week, especially for the mayoral race. Noah, what do you have?
Would you be in favor of a vocational track that steers more high school students into technical careers?
Okay, now who are we going to let go first and answer this question? Start with Mr. Woods. Okay, Tim, we'll buy some time here and give you a second. Would you be in favor of a vocational track that steers more high school students into technical careers?
Yes. It's a fact that not all students are going to pursue, a college. And all of the students need to have the opportunity, whether it be technical training or college or whatever, to prepare for their career, regardless of what it is. But yes, I think that would be great. It's not just one level of students coming out of high school. I think you have to have every single student prepared for whatever avenue that they want to take.
Very good. Thank you, Tim Woods, school board candidate, District 4. Will we use the same question again, or do we want to go to a new question? New question. Brent Shanning, editor of the Pilot Press, will do the honors. Brent?
What is your vision for future educational success in Campbell County?
Okay. Let's do that one more time. What is your vision for future educational success in Campbell County? Who will be our next person? Go right down the line. Okay. Ms. Fay. Our question is, what is your vision for future educational success in Campbell County? Fay Hibberley.
Thank you. And that's a very good question. I think the beginning is to build on what we've got. What we've had and what we've got is good, but we want to be better. And I think one of the things that we need to strive for is to raise our test scores, to raise our gains. I realize that we're not where we would like to be with that. I think it's very important that we be a voice to our teachers, that we listen to our teachers, because they're out there in front. They're where the action is with the children. We need to be able to listen to them and bring their concerns back to the board to see the things that we can do. I think it's important that we all work together on one common goal, to to offer our children the very best education that we can afford. And like I said a few minutes ago, it's going to be challenging with our funding the way it is right now, but we can build on what we've already got. And I just think that it's important to us to have our children educated when they leave here to where they're ready for college. And when they go to their next school, that they're not sitting there feeling like they're behind and they're not up to date with the other surrounding students. So I think it's important that we look at what we're doing right now and ask what we can do better and what we can involve our, one other thing I think is important that we involve, find ways to involve our parents in support of their children's education. And with all the new standards that are in place right now, more than ever before, parental involvement is more important today.
Wow, you're exactly 2 minutes. Very good timing. Ms. Faye Heatherly with the answer there. And our next question is coming from Boomer. We've picked up, we think, a better microphone this week than we had for Boomer last week. Here we go.
Okay. What's your opinion of Common Core and strict academic standards?
Okay, this will go to Clint Bain. What is your opinion of Common Core and stricter academic standards? This is Clint Bain, candidate for School Board, District 4.
Well, Common Core is a set of standards that are based on mathematics and our language arts, and it was developed with intent to better prepare our children for the workforce or college education. I have read a lot about a Common Core, and there is a lot of it to read. A lot of it's very confusing to read. It's not been proven yet that it's going to be successful, so I don't think any of us know that if it's going to be successful. I hope it's going to be successful. I have talked to some of our teachers, and they have concerns that when these standards are implemented, that it's going to prohibit them to teach it the way that they used to be doing. I don't know if that's true, and if it is, I hope that our teachers will have the flexibility and be able to be creative in the classroom like they've always been to be able to effectively teach our children. Like I said, it's not proven yet. It is a state standard that's going to be put in place, and I just hope that it is successful for all of our children. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you, Clint Bain. Our next question is coming from, we'll go back to Noah. Okay. And I failed to mention that we're asking three questions of each candidate tonight, all the way through, to give you an idea of the format. I failed to mention that in the beginning. Noah?
Do you believe that the superintendent should be elected or voted in by the school board?
Okay, we will go to Scott Hill with a grin on his face. Scott Hill from District 3. And voting for or nominating, here we go.
Boy, that's a good one. It's been a highly discussed topic over the last, I guess, probably 4 years in the state legislature. There's a lot of pros and cons, I guess, to each one. I think my personal opinion, and not everybody's going to agree with me, and that's fine. I think that by electing a group of individuals, like myself and the current board that sits, the voters entrust us to take on that responsibility. Being the director of schools is, I can't even imagine. I sit down and talk to Director Poston sometimes, and he tells me some of the things that have went on, you know, through the days, and it's anywhere from counseling to finances, management, of course. He's responsible for nearly 800 employees within our county, and so I feel like that individual definitely needs to have some certain qualifications, in my opinion, an educational background. That's very important so that they're able to understand. But just not only that, is a management position, because you are responsible for managing that group of people, and it's a very diverse group of people. Your teachers,
which are your certified employees, and then your other employees, which are classified, each have different sets of rules that they have to follow and things that they have to do. And so I feel like that, again, just to reiterate what I said, we elect the school board of directors, and I think that that is one of their main responsibilities. That is one of their main responsibilities. That is the sole employee that we are responsible for, is the director of schools. And so I think that the voters entrust us, hopefully, to make that right decision. It's probably not always going to be the right decision, but that's my take on that. Thank you.
Thank you, Scott Hill. District 3, he is the incumbent. District 3, we now go to Brent Shanding for our next question. Let's try it this way. I think this might be easier.
Actually, I saw Mr. Kidwell shaking his head disagreeing on that, so I'll address the same question to him. The question is, do you believe that the superintendent should be elected or voted in by the school board?
Very good. We might be here all night talking about this. Virgil Kidwell, candidate for District 3.
I've worked in politics around here for a lot of years and dealt with a lot of people. I believe in people making the decision as to who their school board will, as to their school superintendent will be. We've had a lot of problems to happen, to take place, not with Mr. Poston, but before that and after that, you know, before that, where that people that was appointed by the school board members did not do their job when they appointed the school superintendent. I believe that the people got a right to elect who they want to, who they choose. It's their grandchildren, it's their children, it's your children, it's all your, you know, your kids, you know. I know there are a lot of things that we need to do, a lot more things I need to say, but I believe that all the people ought to have a right to choose who they want to be superintendent of schools. That's it. That, because, you know, they're going to have to, they're the ones that are going to have to send their kid down there, and if they have a problem, they have to deal with, you know, the school system. They have to deal with the board members. They have to deal with the superintendent. Everything falls back on the superintendent one way or the other, or his assistants. So I feel like if the people elect them, then that puts a bigger, stronger bearing upon the people. You know, when they elect them, that puts more responsibility on the people to elect someone that will do a job that they want to see done. Thank you.
Thank you, Virgil Kidwell, candidate, District 3. Now, where do we go from here? Okay. This question will go to every candidate.
Okay, Mr. Donald McKenna, how are you engaged the community for improved public schools in the district?
And this question will go to every candidate. How will you engage the community to improve public schools in the district? And this will go first to Tim Woods, candidate in District 4. Tim?
One of the first things is making yourself available for questions, always being open-minded and listening to what everyone has to say. One big thing that I think all the community needs to do is attend school board meetings to see what's going on and the decisions being made. That would be the first thing that I would tell everyone, that you need to attend at least one or two, you know, a year at least, just to see what's happening and how the taxpayers' money is being spent, decisions being made that are going to be affecting everyone's children. The other thing, you know, that I think everyone needs to realize is a strong education system. I mean, it's like a trickle-down effect. It affects the whole community. Jobs, I mean, we see these counties that have big industry, and it's because they have a strong school system. And that's one of the things that I always tell people, you know, the stronger the education system, the more attractive it's going to make this whole community, and the more things it's going to come in and benefit all of us. But open forums like this, I think, is great. Being accessible to everyone, answering questions, and actually taking a proactive approach to help solve problems. So.
Thank you, Tim Woods, school board candidate, District 4. And, Rector, thank you for opening up these doors. I think this is going to make a difference. We go to Ms. Faye Heatherly. How will you engage the community to improve public schools in the district?
Well, I touched on this a few minutes ago about the importance of involving the community and the parents in their educational system. There is a nationwide effort to get people to understand the dynamics of having public schools. And in the National School Board, I read some of that news that came back, and they are pushing to inform the people about our public schools. And I think we need to educate ourselves to the fullest and be aware of all the things that we need in our school system. And another thing I think is just invaluable is our parent-teachers meetings and organizations, and maybe we don't have them in all of our schools, but that is a key way to get parents involved in their children's activities. And one thing is to encourage for everybody to encourage people with children in school to attend their teacher-student sessions that they have. The parent-teacher meetings is just really invaluable. But I think it's important that people can attend the board meetings and know what's going on and get ideas maybe from that, what they can go back and do in their community. But public schools are a great asset to America, and we need to do what we can to hold on to that and to make it the very best.
Thank you, Faye Heatherly, candidate for school board in District 3. We now go to Clint Bain. Your question again, how will you engage the community to improve public schools in the district? Clint Bain is a candidate in District 4.
I think that it's crucial that we have more parental and community involvement in our school systems. If we want to improve our schools, we have got to find ways to get the community and especially the parents involved with the school system. I think it would be very important that our principals at our schools find ways to invite the parents to come in at any time to discuss or have, like I said, meetings monthly or whatever, to get the parents involved where they can come in and find out what's going on in our schools. As a board member, I will continue to reach out and to try to establish relationships with the community. I think that's very important for the community to know, as me as a potential board member, that my door is always open. And if you have any questions that you have about our school systems, you'll be always more than welcome to contact me. And I also encourage that that our community gets more involved and attends the board meetings. That way they can come and see firsthand what's going on with our school systems at the board meetings. Thank you.
Thank you, Clint Bain, candidate for School Board District 4. And Karen mentioned we will, in your two-minute wrap-up, candidates, you may answer a question or reference a question we had earlier that wasn't posed to you, if you'd like to do that. I should have said that earlier, I guess. Let's go now to Scott Hill, District 3, and the question again, how do you engage the community to improve public schools in the district, Scott?
Thank you, Jim.
I think one of the main things, and it's been said over here in just the last couple of minutes, is parental involvement. Our teachers are under very strict standards now, and with Common Core and other things, the evaluation system and stuff that has been passed down from the state and federal level, they're under a lot of stress. They have our students a certain amount of the time through the day, and so if we can develop some type of program to get parental involvement up, we need mentoring. We've got a lot of fine folks in this county, a lot of fine folks that are retired, very intelligent people, and to have them be able to go into the schools and to work with our kids, whether it be during school hours or even in after-school programs, I think would be a great benefit to our school system. Sad to say that we have a lot of our children that are being raised by their grandparents in our county. And, you know, the grandparents have already raised their children, and now they're raising their grandchildren, and so they need that extra help. One of the other things that I would like to see if I'm reelected is I would like to see us hold our school board meetings maybe in different areas of the county so that people have the opportunity to come. They have the opportunity to come and speak to us at the meetings, either during the meeting or after the meetings. And I would like to see that take place. Our director last year was able to do some forums at each school, a meet and greet, and I think that went real well, and I would like to institute that again and try to get that involvement, not just parental, but our community as a whole.
Thank you, Scott. Scott Hill, candidate. He's an incumbent in District 3 for school board. And I go to Virgil Kidwell, District 3 candidate. Virgil, how will you engage the community to improve public schools in the district?
We've all heard parental involvement. And also something I'd like to think would help the parents and help the children would be a uniform dress code where the children wore certain things in the school, maybe not make it mandatory, but put it on the ballot or something, see if the parents wanted it, where the children were always wearing the same thing, and the parents wouldn't have spent so much money on clothes, so much money on everything, you know. There's something to look at. And also one of the things I believe we need to do is we need to let the people know, the parents know, that their children are well taken care of. And I'm going to say something that probably make teachers mad. I believe all the teachers, all the janitors, and everyone in our school system that works in the school system or any county job should be drug tested. I believe we need to drug test to make sure that they are not on anything. The children are your main primary source. They are the thing that really counts. And what we're doing today is we need to keep their safety number one. If they got a uniform dress code, the RSO officer can go by and he can tell who's supposed to be in that school, who ain't supposed to be in that school. He knows who ain't supposed to be there and who is supposed to be there. And that, you know, that would take a lot. And if then if someone is acting up from that school and they're acting out, you know, to say that like they're on drugs or something, you know, the teachers know they have to be mandatorily drug tested, and other employees do. And what that person there that they pull out, the student, would automatically have to face the same thing. This would bring a lot of tension both to the schools and all, into all of us. Thank you.
Virgil Kidwell, candidate in District 3. Our next question from Noah. Noah Smith. Noah, go ahead.
This will go to all the candidates as well. Do you believe that a teacher's performance should be measured upon only students' test scores? If not, how do you believe the performance should be measured?
Okay. Where do we go? We go back to Tim Woods. Want to go in the middle? Where do we go? Point me in that direction. Which is the middle? Mr. Bain, okay. Clint, let's buy you a little bit of time here so you can hear this question one more time. Do you believe that a teacher's performance should be measured only upon the student's test scores? If not, how do you believe their performance should be measured? This is Clint Bain, School Board District 4.
Okay. First of all, the school board does not implement or develop performance evaluations. They are state-mandated evaluations. Do I believe that teachers should only be evaluated based on student test scores? No, I do not. I think that I do fully support teacher evaluations as long as the individuals that are performing the evaluations have the knowledge of the performance, of doing performance evaluations and fully understands the evaluation process. And I think that they always need to be consistent when they're performing evaluations on our teachers. I do believe that teacher evaluations is very important, and it's crucial to ensure that our teachers are performing at their highest levels. So I fully support a teacher evaluation as long as they're being conducted in a consistent manner and always fair. Thank you.
Thank you. Clint Bain, District 4 Candidate School Board. Who's next? Left or right? Let's jump on Scott Hill. How about that? Scott Hill is an incumbent from District 3. Scott, do you believe that a teacher's performance should be measured only upon the student's test scores? If not, how do you believe the performance should be measured?
And that is a good question. And as Mr. Bain said, that evaluation system has been passed down from the state as a mandate of how it is done. No, I do not agree with it. Our teachers work very hard, and as myself, when I was in school, I did well in school, but not necessarily was a very good test taker. And to base that solely on that, I don't think is fair to the teachers. A fairer system, I feel like, would be something that would be based on not just test scores, but performance as a whole. Again, like I said, our teachers work very hard, and they have had a lot of stress and pressure put on them because of this evaluation system.
you know, it's no secret we have different levels of children in our schools, and to base that solely on that, and I know I'm probably rambling, but it is not fair to our teachers, and I do not agree with it. Yes, there needs to be an evaluation system in place, just like everyone is in, if their jobs are evaluated. To make sure that the kids are learning and that they are moving forward, but to base it solely on test scores, no, I do not agree.
Thank you, Scott Hill, District 3 incumbent. Now let's go to Virgil Kidwell, candidate in District 3. And Virgil, do you believe that a teacher's performance should be measured only upon the student's test scores? If not, how do you believe that performance should be measured?
Performance for a teacher. I've worked in a classroom at one time or another, a lot of schools were in here when I was working in the factory, and I substituted in the day. You have 35 children a lot of times, and you got to be involved with all of them, you know. This, you know, talk to all of them, try to help all of them. One might catch on faster than the other, and another might, you know, go real slow, but they might learn more, you know. But your teacher, that shows them students how that they can learn and things like that, and shows that student that they care about them, that they want to help that student out, you know. That's one way to evaluate a teacher, is to see how much they care about their students and how well they try to help their students. Just for test scores alone, no, you don't know. The test scores can jump up and down because of a student maybe being having a bad night or something like that. But, you know, the student is going to depend on that teacher. And listen to me here now. That teacher, it makes a big impact on that student, the rest of that student's life. That when the day that student becomes an 80-year-old, they still remember that teacher that tried to help them in school. They cared enough about them to be their helper and their guide and be their friend. And you cannot evaluate a teacher. A teacher is one of the greatest assets this county or any other state has ever had. A teacher is worth their money and gold, their weight and gold, if they do a good job and help the students. I love my teachers. I went to Wynn Habersham School. I had some good teachers. I've got one over here, the man over here I used to work for, Mr. Morton. I used to substitute for him. He knows my background. You know, the teachers are a great asset, and I thank God for our good teachers. But teachers being just evaluated on the test scores, it's totally impossible because, like I say, that student might have a bad day. That teacher might not have been able to get across to that one to the students the way they wanted to get to it. Maybe the next time they'd be able to get across, and them students would excel, and you'd be ready. And that way, another thing, too, our teachers need to try to make sure that our students are ready to go on to the higher grades. When they get out of high school, they can read, write, and spell. And when they get ready to go take a college exam, they can pass it. If that teacher does all that, they've done good. Thank you.
Thank you, Virgil Kidwell, candidate in District 3. Let's go to Faye Heatherly now. Do you believe that a teacher's performance should be measured only upon the student's test scores? If not, how do you believe their performance should be measured?
I do not believe that it should be measured only by test scores for some of the reasons that's already been stated. I think there should be a group of requirements that they're evaluated on, and they should understand what those things are and how well they perform during their evaluations. There are students that are straight A students, and there are students that are in the middle of the classroom. Grade-wise, there are other students that struggle, and no matter how hard that teacher tries, there's some students that will not be able to perform like the higher school students do, and that not only depends on that faction of it, but a lot of times there's children from situations at home that they do not have any parental support, and they don't have the parents to sit down with them when they go home from school to do their homework. We have parents that sit down when their children come home and they spend hours with their children doing their homework. And that's important, you know, but to evaluate them strictly on just that one test score faction, I do not agree.
Thank you, Faye Heatherly, candidate for School Board District 3. I just realized this is the Elizabeth Asbury Fan Club. Look at all the fans around here. Elizabeth, thank you for those fans tonight. Let's go to Tim Woods. Tim is a candidate in District 4 for School Board. And Tim, do you believe that a teacher's performance should be measured only upon the student's test scores? If not, how do you believe their performance should be measured?
No,
I don't agree with teachers' performance being measured by test scores. Everyone sitting here realizes that. There's too many variables, different levels of children. Tests are good to measure where children are at and what they need help with, but I don't see how we can hold a teacher accountable for something she has, that's something she he or she has no control over. I would like to see the state revisit the whole evaluation system. You know, when it's other counties besides us, teachers are complaining all over the state, revisit it and look at different formats of, you know, how to evaluate teachers. And I think Clint said that I believe that we need to make sure that the people that are administering these evaluations are qualified. And then not only after the evaluation is done, making sure that the follow-up, you know, if a teacher is needing help in a certain area, make sure that follow-up's done and they get the support that they need. So.
Thank you, Tim Woods, candidate for school board, District 4. Now we have our wrap-up session. That went pretty quickly, didn't it? 2 minutes for each candidate, and if there's a question that was not asked of you, and you'd like to answer that question that we asked this evening, please feel free to include that in your two-minute closing. And we'll start with Virgil Kidwell, District 3 school board candidate. Virgil.
Thank you, Mr. Freeman. He says we have to think 2 minutes here, and it's hard for me to talk 2 minutes and hush. But I think especially something that is so good that I really enjoy, and that's school. About school. I used to substitute, I said, in the school, and I know what a great, it's a great thing to be able to come into a classroom and, you know, just be a substitute, a little, you know, here and there. You get, you know, be able to bring things to pass. Yeah, I like one reason I want to run for school board, I want to see more done to excel for students. I believe our students can excel more if they, you know, if the teachers has time to take, you know, to, like I said, to talk to them and bring about, you know, a reasonable way of coercing with them, being able to adjust to them and show them the right things they need to do. I enjoy sitting there with 35 students and one asking you this question, another one asking you that question, and sometimes you didn't have the answer. I've had said many times when I was substituting in the school system, I'd have to go ask another teacher. I didn't want to mislead that student. I didn't want to give that student the wrong thing. I could go ahead and look in the back of the book and tell them the answer, but I couldn't show them how to work the problem. We need to take and really respect our teachers, and we need to have a school board that cares and knows and understands how good it is, you know, what the system really is all about. A lot of people don't have no idea what the school system is all about. They think you send the kids to school, forget about it. I appreciate you vote for the election for the school board member. Thank you.
Thank you. That's Virgil Kidwell, District 3 school board. Now with Scott Hill, incumbent in District 3.
Thank you, Jim. And I just want to real quick, the very first question that was asked about the technical path in our school system, I'd kind of like to just address that real quick as to say that we have partnered in the last little bit with the Technology Center down here for them to come in and use our school, our high school, in the evenings for class. They're packed up down here. There's so many people going that route. And so we have started that process with them. And to be able to develop those programs and actually get them in the schools through the day would be great. In closing, I just want to thank Mr. Freeman and the panelists, WLAF and La Follette Press, for holding this here tonight, and also to Jacksboro Middle School and Mr. Rutherford for allowing us to use his facilities. This is a great way for us as candidates to get to interact with you all, voters, and vice versa, and it's been a great event this evening. I hope that after tonight that you have a better understanding of where I stand and how I feel about our school system. I feel very strongly but our continued growth and our success, it will continue. Great things are happening in our county and in our school systems, and we have made great strides over the last 4 years. So I humbly ask for your support and your vote for the 3rd District voters that are sitting here tonight to continue that growth for our future generations to come and for our county as we continue to move forward. Thank you.
Scott Hill, incumbent District 3 school board. Now to Clint Bain, school board District 4.
Again, I would also like to thank both WLAF and Channel 12 for the invitation to attend this event tonight. I also believe that this is a great opportunity for the community to get to come out to meet the candidates, to find out what we stand for, to see what our opinions are, and I think this is a great opportunity to do that. I do believe that I bring some good qualities to the table for the school board with my educational background and my work experience. I am the type of person that likes to learn everything that I can about something before making a decision, and especially when we're making decisions that affect the children in Campbell County and their education, you need to know what you're making a decision on. And I think it takes a lot of good qualities to be an effective school board member. I think you need to be a good listener. I think you need to be a good communicator. You need to be dedicated in what you're doing. You need to be respectful of others' opinions and ideas. And you need to be a leader, and you need to be able to make decisions and always make these decisions in the best interest of our children. And one very important quality that I think that a school board member needs to be is a team player. I think our board needs to operate as a team for it to be effective in the duties that it has to perform. And I believe that I have these qualities, and again, I'd like to thank you for your support and your vote. Thank you.
Thank you, Clint Bain, candidate in District 4. We now go to Faye Heatherly, candidate in District 3 for school board.
Thank you, and thank you, WLAF, and thank you, the Follett Press, for taking time to come share these minutes and hours with us. Thank you all that are here in the audience that have come and shown an interest in your system, whichever thing you're interested in the most, whether it's a mayor's or school board or commissioners or whatever. Thank you for being here, for that interest. When I first started on the school board, it was when my husband realized that he had been on the board for 2 years, and he realized after he developed cancer that he was not going to be well, and he called me to his side and he said, "Faye, I want you to do one thing for me, and that is to finish my 2-year term on the school board, because I know you have the same love and passion for the children that I do," because we've done that in church all our lives. But I did that, and I thought, well, I'll do 2 years. I can do anything for 2 years. So once I got into it and I realized the dynamics of being involved in a school board and what all that you can do and what all you can accomplish, then I had such a love and passion for it that I've wanted to stay there. And I feel like all of my experience that I've gained through those years will be very beneficial. And it's hard to cover everything when you're here for just a few minutes. But one thing I don't think was touched on tonight is their partnership with their commissioners. They're here tonight to let you know their feelings and their thoughts. But it's very important for our school board to develop a good relationship with their commissioners. They are our funding body, and we need to be able and ready to tell them why we are asking for certain monies and what we're going to do with that monies is very important. There's other things that I would like to add, but one thing is long range and short range goals. That's very important in any system. So if I've got 10 seconds, I can't say very much more. So Jim, I'm going to give it back to you.
Thank you, Ms. Faye. Faye Heatherly, candidate in District 3. Earlier this evening, Tim Woods sent me a text. He said, "How should I dress tonight?" And I said, "Dress for a hot room." Was I right, Tim? Okay. All right. This is Tim Woods with his closing comments for District 4.
Thank you. Thank you, WLAF, for having this and everyone coming out. I've enjoyed it. One of the things that I look at, you know, the Campbell County school system is the largest employer in this county. Around 500 teachers, not including the support staff, you're looking at in between 700 and 1,000 people. We have about 4,500 plus students countywide. The school board is making decisions that are affecting a lot of people. It's affecting the whole community, taxpayers' dollars. We need to know, you know, what's our vision for next year? What's our vision for 2 years? You know, what's our common goal? countywide with all the schools. 10 years down the road, where are we going to be? How are we going to be competing with, what are we sending out into the workforce and how are we preparing students for careers? It's all important. I think we need to work together, support the administration, keep things moving forward. Brilliant kids in this county, always have been, there are now, and some superstars going out and doing great things in the world, and I just want to do my part to continue to make sure we have that going on, and make Campbell County a place that people want to be. So, thank you.
Very good. Thank you, Tim Woods. Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for Tim Woods, Faye Headley, Ted Bain, Scott Hill, Virgil Kidwell. Just hearing from our school board candidates, districts 3 and 4. And candidates, pick up your Sam Smith business card there and send Sam an email, a couple of hundred words, maybe 300 words, and get yourself featured in his publication coming out the week before the election. But we greatly appreciate you coming out this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome to keep that if you'd like to, a little souvenir. As we're going to bring on our mayoral candidates, if they haven't melted yet. So, gentlemen, come on up, and we will change our nameplates here. We are live on the radio, so we're having to fill a little bit of time here on WLAF La Follette. Gentlemen, just take a seat wherever it may be coolest for you. Not sure what's on our panel this evening is Boomer Winfrey, Noah Smith, Ben Shandy, Joe King is the clock operator. Karen Kumich, I guess, is our referee tonight, maybe. Gary Carter is behind the camera. We have that black and white, it's not striped though. As we have E.L. Morton, Marvin Rutherford, Fred Cole, William Baird, and Jack Lynch is deciding where he's gonna sit, and there we go. As we're passing out a little water, if you're listening by radio, it's very warm here this evening. We're at Jacksboro Middle School in the cafeteria. Dwayne Wilder is here this evening. He's the roaming reporter for us. Camera and pen in hand, and we will be opening with a two-minute chance for you to mention your platform, maybe introduce yourself a little bit, candidates, and we will give you cues, time cues in your ear, about a minute or so when you have that much time left. But you'll have 2 minutes of opening comments. We'll ask each candidate 3 questions, and then we will close with 2 minutes of comments. You may come back and answer a question that you weren't asked that you might like to respond, and of course ask for folks to vote. Gentlemen, are we ready? Okay, are we warm enough? All right, Karen, who will we begin with? Where should we begin tonight? We'll start with the old man here, the incumbent, William Baird, Mayor William Baird.
Thank you, James. I'm William Baird, current county mayor. I have 26 years experience with state, county, and federal government service. Created a strategic plan for the county that addresses 3 areas. Those are tourism, jobs creation, and education. In the tourism, we want to be able to market our tourism venues and increase the number and the accessibility of those venues. A jobs creation plan is twofold. One is to use our Campbell County Small Business Incubator to grow jobs from within the county. Second is to, we're seeking state certification for a 1,900 acre mega site at the 141 exit on I-75. Once we receive that certification, it can mean thousands of jobs for Campbell County and the surrounding counties and have a positive impact on the whole business environment in the county. Last and probably the most important is our transformation of our education system. We've created a partnership with the local school department to create a learning academy that focuses on five areas, assisting students that fall behind, a dropout program with run state, advanced options for those students needing accelerated learning, faith-based mentoring program for those students that need a strong role model in expanding and improving our arts program. It's all about changing lives to change Campbell County. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor William Baird, the incumbent for Mayor of Campbell County. We now go to candidate Jack Lynch. Jack?
Thank you, Jim. I'm Jack Lynch. I was born and raised in Campbell County. I'm basically a school teacher. I have 30 years experience teaching in Campbell County schools. I've been working all my life, about 40 years here in the county, I guess, along the way. I decided to run for mayor because there's a lot of things that I agree with, there's a lot of things I disagree with. I disagree with some of the things that are happening, the way that we're carrying them out, and so on and so forth. And I didn't feel like I was being represented, so I'm running to represent the people. Well, that's why I'm running. I was born in this county. I was born in Powell Valley or Valley View community. I was youngest of eight kids. We grew up on a farm, didn't have a tractor till I got in high school. We use horses. It's been a long road we've traveled. But education's a way out, and I applaud some of those things we talk about, others I don't. I thank you for listening to me. My name's Jack Lynch.
Thank you, Jack. We now go to candidate for mayor, Fred Cole. Fred?
Good evening, everybody, and thanks to the people that put this event together. My name is Fred Cole. I've lived here for 20 years. And from my work at Indian River Marina, Reaches, and Jacksboro Metals, many of you know me well. I think people are a little upset with government. They think government is wasting their tax dollars and nothing of consequence seems to happen here, while other counties prosper. I think voters are ready for leadership that is forward-thinking and gets results. One of my missions as county mayor will be to restore people's faith in government. We will have a citizen-friendly, customer service-oriented government, with the customers being the citizens. On creating jobs, the truth is the competition for attracting business, industry, and living wage jobs is extremely tough. Nobody here has a magic hat from which to pull higher-paying jobs. But the people in Anderson County and Loudoun County and other counties are no smarter than us. I believe we can be competitive. I believe I can do the best job of getting us in the fight. I believe the county mayor should be the number one salesman for Campbell County. I will reach out to individuals and institutions and foundations and businesses that can help us to prosper. On education, I have raised 8 children. 6 of them went through Campbell County schools. So far, 5 of them are college graduates. For over a decade, I've been going to parent-teacher meetings and otherwise supporting and participating in school activities. Financially, our county has some hard choices to make. We have to find the path towards more fiscal responsibility. We don't need more government, we need better government. Thank you. I ask for your vote.
Thank you, Fred Cole, candidate for mayor. We now go to Marvin Rutherford, candidate for mayor. Marvin?
I'm Marvin Rutherford. I'm the least known of all these candidates here. I've lived here all my life, and I've been involved in youth sports, and tried to make a difference in the youth of the county, and I would like you to consider me and for your vote as county mayor. Thank you.
Thank you, Marvin Rutherford, candidate for Campbell County Mayor. And I'll go to E.L. Morton, candidate for Mayor. E.L.?
My name's E.L. Morton, and I'm offering my services as mayor of Campbell County. I was born in La Follette, raised in Demery, learned to work hard, put crops in the barn, take care of cattle, take them to market. Worked my way through school, finished an Army career in 2009. We spent your tax dollars around the world in a responsible way. We used the word stewardship when we did it. We trained the people that worked for us to be stewards, and we trained them to do very difficult things in different places around the world. We solved problems. We solved problems by talking to the people that were involved in the problems. That's my platform, is to come out and talk to the people of Campbell County. If I'm elected, I'll be in your district at least once a year. That sounds very infrequent, but it's more than you have now, to listen to you and hear what matters to you. Any plans that we put together should factor your input. 3 or 4 community meetings do not equal your input. Can we do the thousands of things that we could come up with in a forum like this? Probably not. But the five or six things that you need out of county government, we could really focus on with your support. But I think we have to earn your support by coming out and talking to you. So that's a significant piece of what we feel we need to do in county government. Education is extremely important. I come from school teachers. I think we do need to ask school teachers what they think they need to do the job. But there is so much inefficiency in the other side of county government, that's where I think your county mayor should focus. We need to look at what we're getting for our dollar in an ambulance service. I've run an ambulance service before. I had 8 camouflage ambulances we fought across the battlefield. A 30-minute response time for an ambulance service is dead people. If we can't do better than that, we might not need an ambulance service. We've got to look at the business models that are aligned under the mayor's office and make sure the people of Campbell County are getting service for the dollars they're spending. My name's E.L. Morton. I'm a candidate for county mayor, and I'm asking for your vote.
Thank you, E.L. Morton. And who will ask our first question this evening? As we're visiting with the mayoral candidates for Campbell County mayor, it's going to be Noah Smith, freshman to be at Campbell County High School. Noah, go ahead, sir.
How will you bring jobs and revenue into Campbell County?
We'll start with E.L. Morton for that.
Okay.
E.L.? No, let me have that question one more time.
How will you bring jobs and revenue into Campbell County?
E.L. Morton.
Thank you for that question, Noah. We've got to aim at I-75. It's like a website that gets 32,000 hits a day. We've got to beat Tennessee at Jellicoe. We've got to nest into that brand. We've got to take that message to the world. 4 years ago, I recommended we go to Japan. We go to Germany, and we extend a hand to those foreign investors that are here in our community. I was told the newspaper would call it a boondoggle. I believe we're adults. I believe we're in a global economy. We have to reach as far as we can to bring the advantages that reside only in Campbell County. The first 5 exchanges in the state. The Tennessee brand is an extremely strong brand in business, in tourism, around the world, in entertainment. We have to nest into that Tennessee brand. We're the first Tennessee you get. Coming south from the North Pole, pick up I-75, you hit the first county with no state income tax and you're here. There are so many advantages that begin in Campbell County. We have to accentuate that. We have to go out and talk to our employers. We have to spend time with them, look them in the face. Thank them for investing here. Not only foreign investment, but domestic investment can grow as well. Japan and Germany are the largest investors in America as far as foreign countries. We've got excellent pieces of each of those investments here, and they will grow with us. We have to extend our hand, tell them we thank them for being here. We're working to produce a workforce that will generate profits for them and good things for the people of Campbell County. Our tourism base is an extremely important part of growing our tax base. I want high-quality restaurants as well, but when Bojangles puts $3 million into your economy and raises the taxes on that piece of property, people in Campbell County prosper. We're going to continue to grow those things.
Thank you, E.L. Morton, candidate for mayor. Are we going to go to a different question? Is that the case? We will. Okay. Brent Channing of the La Follette Press with the next question. Brent.
Do you believe that all employees should be given raises based on job performance, or do you think that salary wage increases should be given just because an employee has been on the job for another year?
Well, we got one more time for me.
Do you believe that all employees should be given raises based on job performance, or do you think that salary wage increases should be given just because an employee has been on the job for another year?
Okay. Where will we go with this question? Will this go to Mr. Rutherford? Okay. We'll just come on down the line. Let me mention to you, candidates, if you pick up a Sam Smith business card there, Sam would like to get your bio, a couple, maybe 300-word written statement, and he'll put that in his publication just the week before the election. Marvin Rutherford.
I think that your job performance is should be based on your evaluation. That should be your evaluation. How you do your job is very important to people and stuff, and you need your evaluation based on your job performance, not how long you've been there, because somebody could be there for 15 years and not done anything, and some people could be there 2 months and do more in 2 months than the guy who's been there 15 years. So job performance should be based on your evaluation of how you perform your job. Thank you.
Thank you, Marvin Rutherford. As we're visiting with the candidates for Campbell County Mayor, we'll go to Charles Boomer Winfrey for our next question. We'll go to the fishbowl here for this question. Okay, who knows what we may wind up with? All right. Oh, my goodness, it must be about Tennessee football.
Okay, Knox County, which roughly has 10 times the population of Campbell County, only has 11 county commissioners, whereas Campbell County has 16. In Knox County, each of the 11 districts are represented by one commissioner, whereas in Campbell County, each district is represented by three, with the exception of District 3, which has four commissioners. Would you support limiting the size of the Campbell County Commission in order to save county funds or restructuring districts? Why or why not?
Okay. We'll go to Fred Cole with that. That sounds like another Smith question. Okay, Fred, would you like me to ask that again? Oh, you got it. Okay. Good deal. Fred Cole.
Well, in the last election, we had looked at that. The Howard Baker Center for Public Policy in Knoxville has studied this issue. And what their findings have been that smaller governments work better. So I would be in favor of that. I think there's been some discussion about having one candidate from each district or two candidates from each district, and then one or two candidates who run at large. But I think that, I know in some other counties they have even more commissioners than us. I believe over in Claiborne County they got 23 or something like that. But I do believe that smaller government would work better and be smarter, and I would be in favor of that.
Thank you, Fred Cole. Our next question from Noah Smith. Is this going to be a question for every candidate, or is this going to go back individual? Go back individual? Okay. Through all the way through. I was thinking that because we went through the questionnaires here. No.
In summer, the lakes become populated and very dangerous. How will you assess the safety of all boaters, swimmers, etc. on the water, and how will you assess public safety?
Okay, this question will go to Jack Lynch. Jack, in the summer, the lakes become populated, very dangerous. How will you assess the safety of all boaters, swimmers, and such in the water? How will you assess public safety? Jack Lynch.
Thank you. That's a tough question because TVA has so much control there, and people other than the county mayor have a lot more control there than I can really say. I agree with you that it gets crowded, and there are times when it's probably dangerous. I personally don't go out on the 4th of July on my boat, and I don't go out on Memorial Day or Labor Day. Those are the days that I stay in. But, I understand that there is a danger there. The sheriff did have a boat. I suppose he still does. I mean, we could ask him to upgrade the patrolling of the lake, things like that. But most of that is really under TWRA, really.
Thank you, Jack Lynch, candidate for mayor. Our next question is from Brent. Brent Shanning with the La Follette Press. Brent.
Can the coal industry be revived in Campbell County?
That may be a question for Boomer. And we go to Mayor William Beard for this question, Mayor.
Thank you. The coal industry in the past has been the lifeblood of Campbell County and the county surrounding Campbell County. Environmental issues were a problem, but the coal industry has changed, and they mine coal in a safe and environmentally friendly way. There's issues with changing our power plants and so forth, changing them over from fossil fuels, but there are new technologies that are coming out to find new uses for coal, and yes, I feel that the coal industry can be re- re- revived here in the county, and one of the things that is probably going to happen this next year that will make it easier to get coal permits is the state legislature is going to have the state of Tennessee to take over primacy, meaning that the state will be in charge of issuing permits and enforcement on our coal mines, and that will be a much, instead of a 2-year or 5-year process, I hope to get it down to a 6-month process. Thank you.
Thank you, William Baer, the incumbent mayor. And now we will go to a question, one question that will be asked of all the candidates, and we was going to ask that question.
Okay. I'm going to divide slip away from the format and ask a question off the top of my head instead of out of the written thing. Mayor Baird, in your advertising and your opening statement tonight, you talk about partnering with the private sector and foundations to help promote education in this county. Now, the proposal that you put forward that was mentioned in the Follett Press last week met with less than enthusiasm from the school board at Tuesday night's meeting. I'd like to know if you have a plan for how you can get the mayor's office to support education and at the same time avoid turf wars and avoid touching on people's feet and getting into that whole sort of thing where, you know, this is not your business.
Yeah. Okay. We'll go to Mayor Baird for this response. Mayor.
Thank you, Boomer. Yes, the learning academy that we're going to implement, the county mayor's office and the school department have partnered in this, and what the county mayor and our Campbell County Community Foundation's role is in this is to provide funding outside of the regular tax dollars that go into the school system. The education department will be responsible for coming up with the curriculum and executing that. We won't have anything to do with that. We'll provide funding for the equipment and the curriculum, whatever curriculum they decide to use, and we will provide training for the mentors that will be mentoring the kids, and that will be our role. So there shouldn't be any turf wars. We won't be telling them how to do it. We'll just be helping them fund it.
Okay, thank you, Mayor William Baird. Now, will we ask the same question of the other candidates, or?
Okay. Which is, how would you work with the school board in such a way, to get them to feel involved with whatever you're doing to promote education, from the mayor's office?
Okay, we will go to Jack Lynch next on the list here, as we're talking with the mayor candidates for Campbell County. Jack.
Thank you. This is one of those things that I disagree on, really. I believe the school system should run schools. We elect a school board to do that. We hire the best director we can, and we should expect him to be the lead on that, and he should lead there. Yes, we should support education, but do we? And we should support adult education instead of some of these virtual schools we're talking about. If we're talking about a virtual school and learning on the internet and this, that, and the other, I'm not for that. I'm for spending money here locally and letting local people. To me, this is more like big government telling little people what to do. And I'm against that. I think that the people here can decide what they want to do. If you want to build education here, you take care of what we got. If you want people who are dropping out to do better, invest in adult education. I taught it 10 years in the jail. I've got some success stories. It works. Virtual schools never work. I haven't found anywhere where they have. They lose money. It's putting private industry into the government. I'm against those. Thank you.
Thank you, Jack Lynch. We now go to Fred Cole. Fred?
Well, I believe the county mayor's office should participate in working on trying to improve education here however they can. I think I have good, strong relationships with many teachers,
and a longtime friendship with the director of schools, Mr. Poston. And I think that I could work together with the school system, no problem, to try to improve education outcomes. But I do think that, you know, the education is an important part of industrial recruitment and bringing people here to Campbell County. And I applaud the efforts of Mayor Baird and other folks that have been working on these type of things. I think we're in the 21st century, so we have to look at them. They may not work now, but they may work later. And I think that we need to do everything possible to work together to improve education outcomes. So I'm not against technology. I think that we can find ways to make it work for us to improve what we're trying to do here, and that's turn out people with educations that can go on to find jobs and have a good quality life. So that's my stand on that.
Fred Cole, thank you. Gentlemen, who wants another water? Jack? Mayor? Sam, could you help us out there, please? Thank you, sir. It is a little warm in here tonight. We got out now to Martha Rutherford. Marvin?
I go with Mr. Lynch over here. We should help with the school system, but we should not. The success rate of the academy is not good. And I think one in Union County, for example, has failed in the past. So I think we should work with the school system, but for academy, I don't agree with it. Thank you.
Thank you, Marvin Rutherford. Sam, one more water. We can get to Mr. Lynch here, please. Thank you. Now we go to E.L. Norton Candy from here.
Scott Hill still in the room. We're what, $45 million spent in our school system, Scott, every year? The $200,000 program's not going to fix a $45 million program. I think we need to put the trust in the teachers that are in the school system, and I'm looking at some right now that I have faith and confidence in to go out there and teach our children. There's too many people telling teachers what to do in the classroom now. I know about mentorship. I believe in education. I secured Masons while they built schools, and when the Taliban blew them up, we went back and built them again. I believe in education, but I don't believe you run it from the mayor's office. You got plenty of government on top of your education system. Hold them responsible. Let them do the work.
Thank you, sir. E.L. Morton, candidate for mayor. Our next question, this is number three. Okay, we're asking candidates a total of three questions this evening. And candidates, following this third question, we will allow you 2 minutes to close and maybe respond to a question that you weren't asked. Brent Chanding.
Sure. So this question will go to all of the candidates. This is a question that I get from a lot of readers with complaints, complaining about the conditions of roads in Campbell County. I talk to them every week about this. As someone who lives on a gravel road myself, here's the question. According to the road superintendent, at the present rate of funding available for repaving roads, it would take more than 50 years to resurface all county roads. Do you agree with some suggestions that the less used roads be converted back to gravel? Would you support raising taxes or making spending cuts elsewhere to pay for paving projects? And we'll start with Mr. Cole.
Okay, thank you. We will go to Fred Cole, candidate for mayor. Fred?
Well, we do need better roads. I have long time, I think that we have a major traffic problem in the making over the next decade or so, because this road that we have out here is not going to be able to handle all the traffic that we will have 10 years from now, 15 years from now, and it takes that long to get a road built. But a while back, they had a referendum, I guess, on a half-cent sales tax that was going to be for roads, and that was the fairest way, really, of trying to raise money, because it spreads it evenly among people that use the roads. People that don't live here pay same as people that do live here. I think that there's money in government that we're going to have to start cutting some waste. You know, we're going to have to find the dollars to improve our roads, and I think that Mr. Potter does a pretty good job keeping up the roads that we have now with the resources that he has, but one way or another, we're going to have to come up with some more money to pave roads. But I don't think that we should turn them back into gravel roads, the ones that we have now. I think that they could probably do a better job filling the potholes and different other things, but we've got limited resources here, and But I think that there is more money there to devote to roads, so we'll have to just take a look at it and see what we can come up with.
Thank you, Fred Cole, candidate for mayor. We will go now to Mr. Rutherford. Okay, Marvin Rutherford, sir.
We do need better roads in the county, but I think we need to look at our wasteful spending in government to cut back to find other ways and means to fund the road, help Dennis Potter do his job better. I mean, Dennis does a great job of what budget he's got to work with, and I have no complaints with him, but we do need to cut wasteful spending back in government to try to help without raising taxes for the people. We're taxed to death as it is now. We need to look at ways to cut wasteful spending out of our government to help fund the roads.
Thank you, Robert Guthrie. We now go to E.L. Morton, candidate for mayor.
Gibson County, Tennessee is a community of 50,000 people in West Tennessee. It's out there in soybean fields and cotton patches. The roads are straight and flat, and the intersections look like plus signs. They got 50 million people. It's a $30 million economy. We have a $73 million economy and tax base here in our county. Gibson County's got $5 million in their roads budget every year. You can go on the state comptroller's website and look at the audits. It's there. A $30 million economy has $5 million worth of roads. We're a $73 million economy. We've got $3 million worth of roads, and we pay the gas bill for your sheriff, your honor guard, and so many other vehicles out of that. I think we've got to allocate and require the pieces of government that use fuel to reflect it in their own individual separate budgets and show a real cost for running your roads departments. Our priorities are wrong. If Gibson County can pay $5 million worth of roads, and all we're coming up with is two. So, no, we don't need gravel roads. Go up to White Oak and shoot through that one-mile section up there and tell me if you want more gravel roads. That's not the solution. We do have an opportunity. The collision rate on this four-lane is unacceptable. We need TDOT to help us evaluate it and find a better way to approach it. I don't know if it's all the signs that we have in the median or if it's lighting and paint schemes, but we need to look at those, because the resources to build more roads are going to come from outside the county. We've got the resources to attract people to come and spend a week at a time with us and leave enough revenues to improve our roads budgets. So I think you look to the tourism opportunity when you look at a road solution.
Thank you, E.L. Morton, candidate for mayor. We now go to Jack Lynch. Jack?
Thank you, Jim. No, I do not want gravel roads. I don't think anybody does. There's not a good answer for that. It's part of the infrastructure that we have to live with, but now infrastructure has to be improved. We're sitting here talking about tourism. Bring in all these people. You can't bring them in without good roads. You can't have commerce without good roads. So the answer is we're going to have to cut back. We're going to have to find waste. I believe that I can do that. I believe I can nitpick that deal in that budget, and I believe I can find some waste to help with those roads. Whether or not it comes to taxes, I don't know. We'll have to see when we get in there and find out. We'll have to dig a little deeper. But nobody wants to go backwards. We want to go forward. We can't do that on gravel roads. No.
Thank you, Jack Lynch. You gave you too much mic cable, huh? About 20 feet worth. Now to Mayor William Beard.
Thank you, James. No, we do not need to go back to gravel roads. This is a problem that every county across the state faces. It's a problem that the state faces. We're seeing decreases in our road tax, the gas tax that goes to pay for our roads and so forth. But back to what I said to begin with, if we're going to expand our economy here in Campbell County, we have got to improve our education system. We've got to have our students and our employees ready for the jobs of the 21st century. We have to do that by educating our kids. And my education plan will work to do that. And as we expand the tax base, then we will have more money to pave roads.
We're not going to be able to increase property taxes enough to do that, and I'm not for that. As Fred said, the sales tax would have produced about $800,000+ a year, and that would have been a big step in the right direction. But we've got to expand our economy here in the county to be able to pave our roads and keep up with our roads, and we've got to have good roads to attract business. Thank you.
Mayor William Beard, thank you. Now, for closing comments, gentlemen, you'll have 2 minutes each, and you may talk more about your platform, go back to a question that was asked earlier that maybe wasn't posed to you, and respond to that if you like. We'll start with you, Warden. Yeah.
Jim, I'd like to go back to the question of safety on our waterways. Every waterway below Norris Dam all the way to the Gulf of Mexico has buoy markers in the middle of it. There's no reason why we can't buoy marker our channels and at least separate coming and going traffic. We got people coming off of inner tubes getting hit by jet skis under a quarter mile from Cedar Creek Bridge. That's unacceptable. We're at capacity. We're at carrying capacity for the lake and for the trails right now. The way we're going to add the good things to our tourism base and margin and profit is to increase the quality out there. We put a buoy marker system out there. You can link Wi-Fi on a buoy marker system. You can grow on that, and you can add to your safety factor out there. TVA took the TVA police off the waterway 2.5 years ago. I went to the TVA board, and I asked them to put them back on. They didn't do it, but the other county mayors that were there representing their counties were getting results in their counties from the TVA board. You drive that system from the top down. We don't take what they send out to us. We go directly to the board. They've got a great economic development staff, but if you wait for them to come to you, then you're going to lose. So we can drive that process. They listen every quarter. They're listening to the community. And every time I go, I see a Norris Lake resident or a Campbell County resident up there speaking to the TVA board. So we can drive that process, increase safety, increase profit and margin and quality and technology out in our waterways. If we're able to get that technology on the waterways, it comes to all the ridges that run out to the water. Pinecrest, Demery, Victory, all of them. My name's E.L. Morton, and I'm offering my services to be your county mayor. I'd appreciate your vote.
Thank you, E.L. We now go for closing comments to Marvin Rutherford. Marvin?
I'm the least known of all, and I work 10, 12 hours a day, and it's hard for me to get out and campaign. But if you want someone to take a stand for what's right and stand up for what's right and do what's right, I will appreciate your vote and support. Thank you.
Thank you, Marvin Rutherford. Fred Cole with closing comments. Fred?
I'm a citizen who wants to see positive change. I believe having a long-term strategic plan for our county is one important nucleus around which we can build a future that works for us all. 10 years ago, in 2004, I was proposing such a plan called Vision 2020. I couldn't get anybody in the political establishment here interested, but we can still do it. It would be a 6-year plan now, but it would still make a difference. I've never been elected to public office before, but I do have a long history of successful public service that has produced results and improved people's lives. For example, I wrote the grant that established the Czech Community Health Center, which now houses the Veterans Clinic. With help from General Carl Steiner, Tom Steiner, and General Colin Powell, we established America's Promise in Tennessee a number of years ago. We raised nearly $1 million for children and youth programs here in Campbell County. 1 minute. Well, I served for 2 years as chairman of the Tennessee Commission on National Community Service. I'm a graduate of Campbell County Leadership and East Tennessee Regional Leadership and served on those boards. I wasn't born here or raised here, so I don't have a lot of family and friends to help get me elected. But the over 3,500 votes that I've gotten in my last two races came from people who voted for me on the merit of my ideas and plans for the county. I still believe that I have the best ideas and leadership ability to move us forward. I feel well prepared to be for the job of county mayor, and I would like the opportunity to serve. I got one final idea here, and that's there's a house that could be built with all the lumber that's on the side of the road holding up political signs, so I think that we should
the candidates and their troops should gather up all that lumber and donate it to Habitat Humanity and see if we can't get a house built.
Thank you. I appreciate your vote.
Thank you, Fred Cole. We now go to Jack Lynch for closing comments for Mayor.
Thank you, Jim. And I will donate my table for us. I promise. It comes down to this. You know, you're talking about, we've been talking about roads. We've got a lot of things in common. We've got some things we disagree on. That's okay. That's why we're different. But it comes down to, you know, do we have to tax? Do we have to raise taxes? That question was asked. In my opinion, it comes down to either taxes or growth. We've got to either grow the economy or we've got to tax it. One of the two. My vision is to grow it, and I've talked about that. We talk about tourism up here a lot. That is like part-time income, a lot of it coming in off the lake, and it's, you know, once a year, if you want to call it that. You have to mix that with industrial jobs in order to make that economy grow. The money that comes in from a paycheck every week from industrial jobs rolls through the economy differently than one-time input money. It rolls through maybe 10 times before it bleeds off in taxes and other things. So I'm the guy that says we want to grow. We want to grow something, and I'm going to be more active, I think, and try to find those jobs if we can. This is representative government. What is that? That's where you hire someone or elect someone every so often to represent you. I ask you to let me represent you. I'm Jack Lynch. Thank you.
Thank you, Jack Lynch, candidate for mayor. Now for closing comments, Mayor William Beard.
Thank you, James. For Campbell County to grow and prosper, it all depends on education. We have to have an educated workforce to fill those jobs. We get passed over before we ever know that we're in the running because of our education system. Our kids lose hope of what's next for them. That's the reason they drop out of school. And how do we fix that? State government's not going to fix it. Federal government's not going to fix it. You folks sitting out there are going to be the ones that have to get involved. We need community support in order to fix this. And it can be, it's going to be hard, but it can be done. And I'm asking for your support. And my jobs program is proving a success. We've got our small business incubator has, over the past 18 months, has 62 clients. They've created 165 new jobs. They generate over $13,700,000 in annual revenues. It's working, folks. Let's get behind William Barrett, your county mayor.
Thank you. Our mayoral candidates, William Beard, Jack Lynch, Fred Cole, Marvin Rutherford, E.L. Morton. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause, please. Gentlemen, thank you. And if each of you will pick up a business card from Sam Smith there, he'd like to hear from you. A couple of hundred words, maybe 300, and email that to him. He's put Monday as a deadline there. Thank you, sir. As we will have candidates for county commission. Sam, let's if we can get a bottle of water to Gary Carter. He's about to burn up out here. If you do that, please, sir. I know you're doing nameplates right now. How are you? Good to see you. As we're going to visit with candidates for county commission from districts 3 and 4, take your pick. You select a seat, and we'll find your name and get your nameplate there to you. As we're at Jacksboro Middle School this evening for our second of three candidate forum 14s from the Lafala Press and WLAF. And we're going to visit with the candidates for county commission, districts 3 and districts 4. Each candidate will have 2 minutes to introduce themselves, mention their platform possibly, and then each candidate will be asked 3 questions. They'll have 2 minutes to respond, also 2 minutes on the opening comments, and then in the end they'll have a couple of minutes to wrap up, ask for your vote, and maybe answer a question that wasn't posed to them during the
interview process. As we have two, four, six candidates so far, still waiting for folks to kind of settle in. Here comes Cliff Jennings. He's a little nervous. He's going to be on the radio here. you sit wherever you want to sit. I'm going to pick a cool spot. Representing Districts 3 and Districts 4. Early voting begins on July the 18th. That's a week from tomorrow. As that is Ralph Grant there, Bill Waddell's best friend. Yeah. candidates for County Commission, as we look at the ballot, District 3, Brett Allen, Wendell Bailey, Scott Gutter, Cliff Jennings, Tammy Wright Milner, Lawrence Rusty Orrick, Jason Shetterly, Scott Stanfield. District 4 candidates, Charles Goat Baird, Johnny Coach Bruce, C. Thomas Burge, Alvin England, Ralph Grant, Roy Green, and Sue Nance. And we have probably about half of the totals of Districts 3 and 4 with us this evening, seven candidates. And we're just about ready, I think. Still passing out some water. Sam, if we could get a bottle of water for Gary. I know you're doing a million things. Gary's on camera here. Thank you. And so the water's been very popular tonight. Yes. Okay. All right. Rusty, that's somebody else's water, I guess. It's about drunk up. I'll get that out of your way. Thank you. Okay, very good. Thomas Burge is here, Sue Nance, Scott Gunner, Rusty Orrick, Ralph Grant, Tammy Milner, and Cliff Jennings, comprising our county commission candidates from Districts 3 and 4. The incumbents, a couple of them are here, Rusty Orrick and Sue Nance. Everybody else is a challenger in this group. As we're getting settled, yes, ma'am? Yes, thank you. As we're trying to get everybody hydrated, we've had a lot of folks skip out on us here. It's a little bit cooler in here than it was maybe an hour ago. But this will be televised on WLAF TV 12 here in a few days. And you'll be able to see it on the Follow Press website, Facebook account, also on 1450WLAF.com in a couple of days, as we are live on WLAF La Follette at the moment, as we're close to getting ready to start our final session this evening. Everybody have water? Everybody has water? Okay, good. It's almost like a sporting event here, I guess, trying to keep everybody hydrated. As candidates, we'll have 2 minutes of opening comments, and then we will ask each candidate three questions. 2 minute time limit on your answers, ladies and gentlemen. And then we'll have 2 minutes of closing comments. Excuse me. Folks, could we quiet down just a little bit? There we go. Thank you. We're ready to go. Who do we begin with this evening, Ms. Karen? Cliff Jennings is a little shy when it comes to radio. Cliff, go ahead, sir.
Well, thank you very much. And I am here, of course, running for Commissioner of the 3rd District. But you know, the first thing I want to do is thank the press and also WLAF and all these candidates, all 96 of them over the county, for having an opportunity and giving us such a good selection throughout the county. I think we ought to be proud of that. For those of you that may not know me, my real name is Clifford Elliott Jennings Sr. On the ballot, it'll just be old Cliff. I served as a La Follette City Councilman for 6 years, 17 years as mayor of the city of La Follette, 23 years preparing budgets. Part of the time during that, with the help of many others, we received over $17 million in grants for the city. We hope to do some of the same for the county. One thing I'm really proud of, in 23 years as a public servant, I never missed a single council meeting, not one. I'd like for you to know that I feel like I'm qualified, I know that I'm dedicated, and I'm ready to serve from day one. I'm Cliff Jennings, and I would appreciate your support.
Thank you, Cliff. Cliff Jennings, candidate for County Commission, District 3. We now go to Ms. Tammy Miller, candidate for County Commission, District 3. Tammy?
I'm Tammy Wright Milner. I graduated from Jacksboro High School in 1975, not too far from this very spot. I left here in I returned to La Follette in 1999 from Atlanta, Georgia. My husband and I have 32 years. I had a business here, Whistleblower, some of you know. And I'm running for county commissioner because I think I can do a good job. I think I'm open-minded and I'll work hard. And I'm a little nervous, so I apologize for that. But the only thing I can really tell you is that I'll work very hard for you. I will not miss a meeting like Cliff. I apologize. I am a little nervous, but I will work very hard for you, and thank you for your time.
Thank you, Tammy. Tammy Miller, candidate for County Commission, 3rd District. We now go to Ralph Grant, who is running for District 4, County Commission.
District 4, city limits of Jacksboro, the rest of the county down that way. My name is Ralph Grant. We've been lacking in leadership for quite a while, and I'm here to offer some. Now, I've never been in a forum that was so hot as this one, but I've been in fights this hot. But honestly, the improvements can be made in our county. But let me go back. I was born here. My dad dug coal down at Caribou Block. My mother worked at the shirt factory. And we were all educated here. Went on to Knoxville, was educated there, still a law fan, regardless of how they do. And then came back and I worked in different positions here in the county. One was preparation of budgets for the county for 6 years. And I gave that up to go start a factory that employed 125 people for 3 years. And people, every one of them that went out there didn't have a job when they went there. And we covered on to that, and I kept trying to get somebody to get a bus to run around here because folks around here don't have any transportation, a lot of them, legally anyway, they don't have a driver's license. But if they'd run a bus from the Liar's Bench in Caribou up to Food Line, stop by the courthouse so people could pay their fines, then go on up and go to the probation office, they wouldn't have to fill up all these highways with cars. They're everywhere out there. And do you know that there was a man making $75,000 a year, decided to cut out the commodities of cheese to the poor people of Campbell County so he could get a raise? Thank you for listening. I love Campbell County.
Ralph Grant, thank you. If I can remind everybody to hold the mic just a little bit closer, Ralph Grant is running for County Commission District 4. Here's Rusty York, County Commission District 3 candidate.
I want to tell you all, I appreciate the press and Jim WLAF for all that you've done. I think this is a good thing. I think that people that's going to be held accountable, they need to come here. I'm not trying to put nobody on the hot seat. It's kind of hard to follow up with that voice of Cliff's, but I'm Rusty York. I'm actually one of your county commissioners in the 3rd District, finishing up actually my second term. I'm going to seek another term. That's why I'm here. But I'm actually one of 10 children of Charles and Shirley York, raised up in Caribou, was taught to work hard, had some morals put behind us. As your commissioner, I've made mistakes. I'll make more. There's nobody sitting at this table that's not going to make mistakes in this room. But I'll do the best possible job that I can. That's pretty much all I can tell you about myself. A lot of people knows me. Budgets are hard. Thanks. Budgets are very hard to have to deal with, mostly when you don't know. But I'd appreciate your support this evening. People out there in the public, keep me in mind. I'll work hard for you, and I'll do an honest job. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Rusty Ward, candidate for County Commission District 3, and now to Scott Gunner, candidate for County Commission District 3. Scott?
Thank you.
Well, I'm Scott Gunner, and I would like to thank WLAF and the Fall Press and God for the opportunity to be here this evening. Born in Rocky Top, first time I've actually said that in public, and raised here in Campbell County all my life. I've worked 19 years down here at A&S as a welder, worked 5 years at our local Walmart kitchen shoplifters in the evening time. Married to my wife Susie, and we have two beautiful children, Laura and Jalen. Never held a political office, never ran for any type of politics at all. The topic and do my very best to make this community a stronger place.
Thank you, Scott. Scott Gunner, candidate for County Commission, District 3, now incumbent Sue Nance from District 4.
I want to thank WLAF and the La Follette Press for doing the forum and inviting us to be here. I'm Sue Nance. I'm presently the commissioner in the 4th District and seeking that same position again in the upcoming election. I'm the widow of the late Don Nance, which probably most of you know, and I actually have been a lifelong resident of Campbell County, live on campus here at the middle school right next door, so everybody probably knows where I live also. My background, I've worked for 30 plus years with the Department of Children's Services, working with children and families. Presently, I'm working as a part-time employee in the county clerk's office. I have a master's degree from the University of Tennessee, and one of the things that I will promise to do is always be available to listen to your concerns and to be willing to try to act on those as much as possible. So I noticed the crowd's gotten much smaller, so a lot of the hot air left the room, didn't it?
Thank you, Sue. Sue Nance, incumbent, District 4, running for re-election. And now District 4 candidate for County Commission is C. Thomas Burge. Thomas?
Thank you. I'm glad to be here, and I just want to express my gratitude for all of you coming out tonight. It's so wonderful to see so many people come out and be involved in government. That's the one thing that I tell everybody, including my students. That's right, I'm a teacher. I'm crazy, but I'll do it for them because they're the most important thing we have. They're our most precious commodity, and they oftentimes get thrown underneath the rug. They get overlooked. We need someone on the commission who is not just a teacher, but someone who is there for education. We need representation because everybody keeps talking about the education. We need to fix it. We need to do this. It is not broke. It is on the commission's end to make a better Campbell County for our students so when they graduate, and trust me, folks, they're prepared. We prepare them. The problem isn't that they're not prepared. They leave the school with no opportunity here. They go off to Anderson County, Knoxville, Loudoun. We lose some of our best and brightest. Of the classmates that I graduated with, I can hardly say that a handful of them actually returned here. Most of them left. And those were our best candidates, our valedictorians, the top of our class. And the reason that I'm running for office is because one man, my grandfather, Charlie Green, told me, it is your responsibility, no, it is your privilege to serve in government and make a better future for you and your children. And that is what I plan to do if I'm elected 4th District County Commission. Thank you.
Thank you, Thomas. C. Thomas Burge. After the introductions, we'll go to our first question. And candidates, you'll have 2 minutes to respond. And who's going to ask our first question? Noah Smith? Okay. Campbell County freshman to be? Noah?
What policies or regulations will you enforce in the county to attract big businesses, tourism, etc.?
Okay. Who will be our first person to talk, to answer? Where shall we go? Decisions, decisions. Start on the other end with Thomas Burge. He's warmed up, ready to go. Thomas, your question is, what policies or regulations will you enforce in the county to attract big business and such?
As I just said, we don't have industry. I would like to work close with the county mayor's office to enforce better change, to have a higher standard for the people of this county. We need business to be brought in. We need industry. We have zoned land ready to go. We have factories, yes, but a lot of those factories don't have high-end jobs. As Mr. E.L. Morton said, China, Japan, Germany, all these places, we need to get outside help to come in. There's nothing wrong with it. It is still our money. We're the ones working for it. It is about our children. A lot of times, we forget that. We think about the here and now instead of 50 years down the road. What are they going to do? How will they have a way of life? Because the lake, it'll be here, but in 50 years, will it be polluted? Will we still have that strong tourism? We need to have an established economy, one that encourages and hopefully makes it easy for a big industry to come in. I want to work close and establish policy that is easy for business to come in, where we work with them hand in hand and hopefully with the education system to prepare students for that job so that when they graduate, they have years of experience, maybe 1 or 2 years work experience in that job industry, and they go straight into work. They don't have to build that when they come out. They already have it. They're ready to go. They're established. Thank you.
Thank you, Thomas Burge, candidate for County Commission, District 4. We'll go to another question. Okay. Charles Boomer Winfrey. Don't get one of those six-paragraph questions. How about that? give us a true-false, maybe.
How will you work with the district school system to ensure that the financial needs of the schools districts are met?
Okay.
Who's next in line? Is it Sue?
It's Sue. We're going to go to Sue. How will you work with the district school system to ensure that the financial needs of the schools district are met? Sue Nance, candidate for District 4 Commission.
That's a challenging question, and Boomer's in real trouble for asking me, because it's also one with a difficult answer. There's never enough money to support everything that needs to be done. This year alone, I think we need about $400,000 extra dollars to support the request from the school system that they presently have, not including the insurance that's going to also increase by about $400,000. So it's a real challenge. I think there's got to be better resources in the school system to cut some of the spending in the school system, and I do not mean with teachers. That's not where it should be cut. But we do need to work with the school system to try to see that they can trim back on some of the programs that need to be cut, some of the personnel that needs to be cut, and try to come up with revenue to help them do that. But it's a true challenge. I'm not for raising property tax, and that's pretty basically our source of income for the county.
Thank you, Sue Nance, County Commission, incumbent District 4. And we have our next question coming from the Follett Press editor, Brent Shandy. What do you have?
What questions should be asked before approving new commercial developments and industry projects?
Okay, what questions should be asked before approving new commercial developments and industry projects? Shall we go to Scott Gunter? Just come on down the line. Scott, here you go, sir. Scott Gunter, candidate for County Commission, District 3.
Yes, sir. Here we go.
What policies or regulations will you enforce in the county to attract... that's not the right one. What questions should be asked before approving new commercial developments and industry projects?
Well, to be quite honest with you, that's a question that I've not versed myself in very deeply here. I think before any industry comes into this county, we need to look at what type of industry it is. And we have a lot of businesses that are here that we don't need to follow suit and bring the same type of businesses here. We have to look at the availability of our skill and educational levels of the people available. And I think if you go down to the exit any morning and look at the traffic circling up onto I-75 headed toward Knoxville and Oak Ridge, you'll see for sure that we do have the type of people here that can handle those big businesses that we can bring in. But to be honest, I'm going to have to inform myself on this topic a lot farther. Thank you.
Thank you, Scott Gunter, who's running for County Commission, District 3. We now go back to Noah Smith. Noah?
Do you have experience with complicated budgets? When you are given a large budget for the county, what will be your process to determine if it is a good budget for the county?
Okay, this will be going to Rusty. Rusty Warwick, do you have experience with complicated budgets? When you are given a large budget for the county, what will be your process to determine if it is a good budget for Campbell County? Rusty Warwick.
Yes, I have. Finishing up in my eighth year on County Commission, thrust into it just like the new ones coming this term. And a lot of people don't understand, I'll get off on that real quick. This is also our appraisal year, and we have to wait till everything's in line before we can make a rash or a rational decision. Yes, the budgets are very complicated in the county. There's a lot that you have to cipher out. There's a lot of feeling that you have to put into it. A lot of time you go by page by page, but you have to have assurance from the people that's working in the finance department and the other departments and seeing what their needs are. It's kind of like a big old bologna sandwich and a little bit of mayonnaise. You get to spread it all over the end. But the budgets are very complicated. It's hard to cipher all of them out. And it's hard to look at certain departments and make decisions on cuts. That's pretty much basically it. I mean, I've dealt with the budgets for 8 years. There's a lot to decipher out in the budget, but you have to put a lot of assurance in the people that's working for you. That's pretty much it.
Thank you, Rusty Work. He's an incumbent in District 3 running for re-election. Our next question is coming from Boomer. Is it? Okay, I'm straight here. Go ahead.
Let's see, I've got Ralph. Oh, boy. Ralph, I'm intrigued by your idea about a bus line that would connect the care with the fire. How do you think it could be paid for? How would you finance something like that?
Okay, Ralph Grant addressed a bus in his opening comments, and Ralph Grant running for County Commission District 4. Ralph?
Well, you have to charge people to ride it. It's going to be a free bus. I know you're a Democrat. You're used to that, but no free bus either. But I'm sure that enough pressure can be put on Ethel to get it started. And there's grants that I know are available that I looked into many years ago. There's always a way to do it if you want to help your fellow man. Lord, right away.
All right. Thank you, Ralph Grant, candidate for County Commission, District 4. And we return to Noah Smith for a question. Oh, Brent, I left you out a second ago, didn't I? You should have told me. Okay, here we go, Brent.
Okay. The question is, what qualifications do you acquire that make you feel fit for the job?
Okay, what qualifications do you acquire that will make you fit for the job? We'll go to Ms. Tammy Milner, candidate in District 3. Tammy?
I guess my qualifications are that I have run a couple of businesses, a great desire to try to improve the situation in Campbell County, and I'm not sure you have to have... I'm getting a little off track, but I think that you can, as long as you're an honest individual, you work hard. I've run a budget for my husband, I've run a budget for myself, and I think that we can, I'm sorry, I even lost track of what the question was. Oh, my qualifications. My qualifications are that I have run a business. I have dealt with budgets. I've run my husband's business. I run my mother and father's business. And I feel that I am qualified for this. I bring honesty to the table, and I'm not afraid to go door to door and ask you what you would like if something's not being handled correctly. And I guess that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Tammy Miller, candidate for County Commission, District 3. Now it's Noah's turn, right? Okay, we're back at where? Noah?
How will you attract industry and business to Campbell County?
Okay, we'll go to Cliff Jennings. Cliff?
Well, thank you very much, and that's a question for all of us, but one thing that I would certainly like to do, and I think it's something we can do, should have done a long time ago. We have an influx of people in this county that have moved here. ECOs, CCOs, presidents, vice presidents, they're out there at Deerfield and places like that. They mow the grass, you know, they have a beer and play a little golf, and all that talent is out there. I think we could take a breakfast or two and go out there, get those people together all over the county, give them the recognition when they perform, and what I mean by performing, they have the experience, the contacts, that it would take a commissioner or a county mayor years to build. People that have gone after industry, and I look at some of you over the room this evening, it takes sometimes years to get into the door. We've got hundreds of people that have managed factories and companies all over the United States of America, sitting right here in Campbell County, Tennessee, and they would be willing to help. I contend that the simplest way that the commission and I have every intentions of going to the first district commissioners and asking for their involvement to go to Deerfield to start with and look for these people. I have talked to some of them. They are willing to serve, free of charge, I might add. A breakfast, you know, lunch here or something, nothing great, not a lot of money spent overseas or nowhere else, spent right here at home. The potential is here, they're here, we just need to work after them.
Thank you. Cliff Jennings, candidate for County Commission, District 3. Now to Brenda Winfrey, and where we'll begin, Brent, when we go back. This is a question for everybody, okay. We'll start with Cliff and work as he's warmed up. Everybody, I think everybody's warmed up. Okay, Charles Boomer Winfrey's going to dig out a question from the fishbowl. Charles?
It's a nice general question. What are your top priorities for Campbell County? How would you work with other elected officials and county staff to implement that vision?
Okay, we'll go to Cliff Jennings. What are your top priorities for Campbell County? How would you work with other elected officials and county staff to implement that vision? Cliff?
Okay, experience helps me a lot because I've had to deal with this for many years. As I said, serving 23 years in the La Follette government. If you all remember, I was the one that started, along with my commission and my council, I was the one that started the workshops. When I first got in politics, they'd give them 3 votes and the heck with what you thought. They wouldn't even tell you what was going to be on the agenda. When I got elected mayor, I felt like that the only way that my council could do a good job is to know everything that I knew and what they knew. So we started the workshops. You've got to work with your commission. Will I be one of the Super 8 or the Sad 7? Never. And the reason I won't be is because I can't agree with everybody all the time on anything. And how they can come up with 7 or 8, and we've all heard this, how they can do that, I don't know. I've not figured it out. But what we need to do, I think industry is, of course, it's the answer to so many of our problems, our roads that they talked about, routes, bus, and everything else. But it takes a group of individuals being the commission to work with whomever the mayor is, and I mean work with them. I hear them say, gosh, we had a meeting lasted 2 hours. My God, you make $500 a month. Why would you cry about working 2 hours a month? If it takes 6 hours, that's fine. But we need to get it done. We need to put our self-interest aside and really do what we say we're going to do up here and mean what we say when we're working for you, the people. And I'll try to do that.
Thank you. Cliff Jennings, candidate for County Commission, District 3. Tammy, I'll repeat this question. We'll do it all the way down the line here. What are your top priorities for Campbell County? And how would you work with other elected officials and county staff to implement that vision? Tammy Miller, candidate in District 3.
I would begin by working with the civic leaders, the church leaders, the Chamber of Commerce, the commission, the mayor, and all the above approach. It takes everybody, as they've indicated before by the mayor, Cliff. It's not a one-person situation. You have to have everyone involved. I would like to attempt to do that. I would like to improve the image of Campbell County, both the school system, separate perception from reality as to whether our schools are actually as bad as they are or say they are, because when I had a business, I had several employees from the school system, and let me tell you, there is nothing to be ashamed of. They were awfully wonderful, and I was doggone proud to have them, So that's what I would do. I tried to work with everyone to try to improve all the above, and hopefully all of you would help along with that. And I think that's important since you're here. Obviously, you care about the county. I care about the county. I come back here, and I think that says a lot when you leave and come back. I just love Campbell County and love all the people that I've met since living here. So thank you.
Thank you, Tammy Miller, a candidate for District 3, County Commission. We go to Ralph Grant next. Ralph, what are your top priorities for Campbell County, and how will you work with other elected officials and county staff to implement your visions?
Oh, I can get along with all of them, but I can fuss with them too. But my top priorities, I think I've mentioned a couple of them, but we're suffering so bad right now with these appeals in this county. People I see that shoot up their arm full of poison, and we don't do a thing for them. They put them in jail. It's sad. The very poorest, hungriest of our people are ignored. Just let them go. Even I heard a senator talking, and he said he was for the working poor. There's a lot of people poor that don't work. And they're just out there starving to death for different things. That I would like to see something done there, and I would work to try to accomplish that.
Thank you, sir. Ralph Grant, who's a candidate in District 4. We go to Rusty Orrick. And Rusty, again, what are your top priorities for Campbell County, and how will you work with other elected officials and county staff to implement that vision?
Thank you. Actually, the industry is the biggest thing on the plate. I know it's very hard with the economy that we have to try to bring industry into Campbell County. Education is another thing that we need to put every opportunity into to educate our children. The commission, as Cliff said, workshops are something that is needed. You just can't go into a meeting and make a decision. You have to have time to study out things. You have to have time to debate things out. And we do workshops, but sometimes it's kind of rushed through and it's trying to push things through. But all elected officials, I don't care if it's the highway department or if it's the register of deeds, they need to get involved in the county government. They need to try to help every way that they possibly can. Campbell County, it's not just, Campbell County is actually no different from any county in the state of Tennessee. We're all in trouble. The economy's bad. But you have to have people that's working. You have to elect people. You need to elect people that's going to get out here and work for you. I believe in that. I believe in trying, but one person can make a difference, but it takes 8 votes on the county commission to get anything done. But you're also the mayor, and I'm not pushing any mayor by any means, but the mayor has a big part to play in the county government. The county commission is not a full-time position. It actually is, but it's not. We all go to work, and we try to do the best job we can for our families. You come in at night, and you lay down. Before you lay down, you try to go through everything that you've got and try to make the decisions, the best decisions made for the county. Not throwing off on any elected official, but go back to all those elected officials that's drawing a paycheck. They have just as much to put into it as I do. More to gain, really, to make Campbell County better. I think the basics. Going back to the basics, your family going back to the basics, it makes it, I guess, a lot of time. But I appreciate you listening.
Thank you, Rusty. I didn't give you a cue, a time cue. Sorry about that. Rusty Warwick, candidate for Campbell County Commission, 3rd District. And we now go to Scott Gunner, candidate in 3rd District. And Scott, what are your top priorities for Campbell County, and how would you work with others to implement that mission?
Well, my main focus and top priority for this county, and it should be everybody in this community's top priority and focus, is our future, and that's with our children and the future residents of this county. Working with the county commission and our mayor and our local department heads, we need to look at internally and make ourselves stronger by minimizing waste and spending. Before we look toward raising taxes toward our public, we need to educate ourselves, and I'm talking about commission members as well as the general public, and we have to strengthen each other on the commission to make our community better. If I inform myself of a situation or a subject, I want to look to the other people on the commission and make sure that they understand it the same way I understand it, so we'll be on the same page. And That's my top priority, is so that we can bring clarity and a better future for our community. Thank you.
Thank you, Scott Gunner, running in 3rd District for County Commission. What are your top priorities for Campbell County, and how would you work with other elected officials and county staff to implement that vision? We can now go to Sue Nance from District 4. Sue?
I've been on the commission for 4 years, and I think we strongly have missed the mark by not having an industrial, paid, qualified industrial recruiter in Campbell County. And yes, that costs money, but also it could bring more revenue into the county. And that's where we've got to focus, is increasing the revenue and cut the wasteful spending. I would work with all the departments to cut out spending that's not necessary, and I would be a big advocate for having a qualified, paid industrial recruiter.
Thank you, Sue Nance, candidate for County Commission District 4. Also running for County Commission District 4 is Thomas Burge. And Thomas, what are your top priorities for Campbell County, and how would you work with other elected officials and staff to implement that mission?
As it's been said down the line here, Sue, Rusty, all of us, we understand industry is the key. With industry, everything will blossom. It will grow our education. It will grow our revenue. It will make our roads better. It will make Campbell County a better place. It will make it more open and more friendly. We need to make it a business-friendly county as best we can. It's already being implemented with some policies, but it's not enough. It's never going to be enough. It is a never-ending problem. We have to constantly hold ourselves to a higher level. If we want to hold our kids' education to higher levels, we have to do that in the county. We have to say it's not good enough for our kids. Our kids deserve better. We as a county deserve better. And to do that, we have to push industry. Industry is the key. But as Rusty said, it's hard right now. But I agree with Sue. You've got to invest money to make money. But you've got to have wise investments. And you've got to cut that wasteful spending. Everybody knows what I'm talking about. You hear it. But what it really takes is someone to sit down and say, do we really need this? Or can we cut this back and still function? Because bottom of the line, folks, decisions are hard to be made. It's not a business. It's a government. They're people. These numbers are people, and their lives are in our hands, and we have to make the best Campbell County that we can with the time that we're given here. Thank you.
Thank you. That's Thomas Burge, candidate for Campbell County Commission District 4. Now, we're going to go to a final question, and then in your closing comments coming up, we'll also have another question that we'd like for you to touch on as well. Brent?
The last question, we'll start with Mr. Urich, and we'll go to everyone. How will you address nepotism when it comes to hiring county workers or appointing board officials?
Okay. We'll go to Rusty Urich, who is a District 3 County Commissioner running for re-election. And Rusty, how will you address nepotism when it comes to hiring in Campbell County?
Yeah, that's a very good question. It's been brought up in the past. I see some commissioners that sit on me with my first-term lens. He's brought it up different times. There's a lot of things that the Campbell County Commission or any commissioner across the state can do and can't do. Every time it's been brought to the table, I think we need a nepotism policy. But you start looking at a little small town like Campbell County, you run into people that's related down the road. And it gets people's feelings stirred up in odds and ends. But every time it's been brought to the table, that it's been shot down because the county commission don't regulate departments. If you're elected official, and I'm not picking on the sheriff or anybody like that, that's their departments. We don't set policy within our departments. They have to follow through with those. Now, we could start one. I think we tried at one time, and it ended up just blowing up because then the department heads, once it got to them, then they decided they didn't. They was elected by the fish, by the people to do the job. It's something that's hard to deal with. I mean, it would take years to go through, but it's been tried. But a lot of people don't understand the county commission is governed by policies, by the state policies and the statutes. And I think we have one employee, I think, is our secretary. And we can set policy all day on her. But when it comes to other departments, we can't. I'd like to see, and I know it's getting out of the question and we run out of time, but drug testing policy. I heard it talked earlier. I brought it up three different times. Well, we can start a drug testing policy in the county commission, but to hand it down the line to other elected officials, it's left to them. And then when that changes hands, the guard changes, and somebody else gets reelected, they can make that decision again. So I guess we're running out of time.
Rusty, thank you. Rusty Warwick. Who do we go to next, Brent? Ralph Grant. Ralph, how do you address nepotism when you're on the county commission?
Well, that'd be difficult because I think I'm killing the half people in the county, and Darlene's killing the other half. So I don't know. And Scotty Keith's killing all of them. Folks. These election officials make those calls. It's for the county commission to pass any rules and to try to get rid of them, they'd have to start by getting rid of the county commission. There'd be some of them more skinning one another. So, I'm so proud you're out here, Melvin. Melvin Bushers is one of the finest commissioners that ever lived in Campbell County. And Johnny Joe Dyer is the other one. He was back there a while ago. And Melvin don't live in my district. So, but he's probably my cousin.
Thank you, Ralph Grant, who's in the 4th District for County Commission. We go to Tammy Milner, who's in the 3rd District running for County Commission. Tammy, how will you address nepotism when it comes to hiring county workers or appointing board officials?
I agree that it would be difficult to have a nepotism policy when your county is as small as it is. Even though I haven't been here in years, I've got relatives I don't even know about. So it'd be difficult for me to say I wouldn't hire, or if I was in a position to hire somebody, that it might not be my cousin because I haven't a clue. I would think that a department head, if you could pass a policy, that they would not be able to hire within their department someone that's related to them. So I suppose if I had the ability to vote for such a thing, that would be my stance on it. Thank you.
Thank you, Tammy. Tammy Milner. We now go to Cliff Jennings, who's running in District 3 for County Commission. Cliff, how will you address nepotism when it comes to hiring county workers or appointing board officials?
Well, it took me 9 years, 9 consecutive years, to bring it before the La Follette City Council before I got it passed. So it's pretty evident that I believe in nepotism. I believe if you elect me, you didn't elect my family. And of course, it's easy for me to tell you that I won't hire my family because I'm the only one left. So that makes it pretty easy on me. But anyway, nepotism is something that is tough to deal with. Ms. Milner touched on it. You've got to get it. You can't stretch it out for aunt, uncle, sister. But you've got to get it down and clarify it. And we took the hours. The best I remember, a department head couldn't hire in their immediate family or somewhere along that line. You could possibly get that through a commission if you narrowed it down to her immediate family, maybe. Would it be hard to take through 15 commissioners? It'd be right near impossible, I'd say. But as for do I understand and do I want to see a nepotism policy, I think it works.
Thank you, Cliff Jennings. Candidate in District 3, and I go to Scott Gunner, who's a candidate in District 3 as well. Scott, how will you address nepotism when it comes to hiring county workers or appointing board officials?
Well, I think you'd have to look at the potential policies that could be put in place, as these people were talking about. But also, I think if we hold individuals to a standard, that kind of will take care of itself. If you're doing a good job for the county, and you're performing and you're efficient at your job, then I think that you should keep that position. If we just went through and fired relatives now, we'd be bust right now. But hold them to a standard, and then the people coming into positions, holding them to a standard as well for qualifications. I think nepotism would kind of take care of itself in a lot of ways, just on efficiency and qualifications for position.
Thank you, Scott Gunner. Who else needs the water? Anybody need a refill on water? We good? Cliff, you need another water? Sam, you want to get Cliff the water? Oh, we're fresh out. Oh, well, offer something we don't have. Let's go to Sue Nance now. She's in District 4. Sue, how will you address nepotism when it comes to hiring in the county?
Presently, there's no nepotism law in Campbell County. And Rusty is correct. The commission has no control whatsoever over department heads that are elected by the public, just like the commission is. So you can't tell a department head, such as the county clerk or the trustee or whichever department, who they can and cannot hire or fire. So we have no control over that. We control one employee, and that's 15 people controlling that one employee. So that's not a problem as far as the commission is concerned. And like I said, we have no control over the department heads. The other part, when you're addressing appointments to committees or to committees, departments, the appointments are made by the mayor and approved by the commission, so we don't actually appoint to the committees either, so or to any committees other than just the committees that the commissioners are on, the local committees.
Thank you, Sue. Sue Nance, County Commission, District 4. We now go to Thomas Burge, who's running in District 4 for County Commission. Thomas, how will you address nepotism when it comes to hiring county workers and board officials?
It's like Rustin and Sue said, the law clearly states what we can and cannot do. The fact of the matter is, we can't tell the sheriff, the mayor, who they cannot hire. It's outside of our jurisdiction. What we can do is hold ourselves accountable to a higher standard morally, but outside of that, we as the commission have no power there. Personally, yes, I think there should be some kind of law countywide that prohibits immediate family, but
I'm sure most of you have been in the store, you're talking to somebody in the line, you find out you're third cousins. It's a small community. Here we are, we know each other, we're related. You just never know who you're going to be working with, who's going to come up. Yes, we should hold ourselves to a higher standard, but we have no power as the commission does to say who or what another department can hire. Thank you.
Thank you, Thomas Burge, candidate in District 4. We're not going to go for our closing comments. You'll have a couple of minutes, candidates, and we also have a question we're going to toss in there. If you would also address that as well, please. No, what is that question?
Name a specific item that you would add or cut from the budget.
Okay. And where will we go, Brent? Where do you want to start? Okay, we will go with Cliff Jennings. Cliff, here you go, sir.
Well, for example, if I had to make that decision right now, I don't know. I'll be the first to admit it. I haven't had a chance, of course, not being in there to actually look at the budget. Some things would be harder to cut than others, but to specify one particular item, I certainly wouldn't want to do that right now without first knowing the facts. But I promise you this, there'll be several things that I will be willing to cut. Because I, like everybody talks about here, I don't care if you're out in Greenspan, there's only two or three ways to balance a budget. You can cut your services, you can raise your revenues, or you can do a combination of the two. In Campbell County, from what I understand, the new commission is looking at making some tough decisions related to those three angles, and we're going to have to do it. Do I know one specifically? No. Off the top of my head, I wouldn't want to do that.
Okay, is this my closing?
Okay. First of all, everybody in this room probably knows me. If you don't, you do now. I'm Cliff Jennings. I bring experience, 23 years of balancing budgets, 23 years of working with elected officials, and with a success rate that seemed to follow, received over $17 million in federal grants while I was in office. The last time I took over as mayor, we were $375,000 in the red when I left office. We have a surplus of over $4 million. I am a combat Vietnam veteran, and I'm ready to serve. I'm Cliff Jennings, and I would appreciate your vote and support. Thank you.
Cliff, thank you. Cliff Jennings running for County Commission in District 3. We now go to Tammy Miller. Tammy, the question is, you close in your final 2 minutes. What would you cut from the budget, if need be?
I would have to agree with Mr. Jennings. It would be difficult to make that decision from where I sit right now. I don't know exactly what areas are, if there is wasteful spending, if there is. Once you become county commissioner, you can make that decision at that time and try to take everything into consideration. You don't just pick one. You try to put everything into the area and look and make sure you're making the right decisions because you're affecting people's lives and their livelihood. So it's a hard decision, but one that you have to make. And as has been discussed here, I'm sure after or when the next election or after the election, the next group of commissioners are going to be faced with some tough decisions. And, of course, I feel I can make those decisions, and I'll do it fairly and try to ask each department head if to look at their own books to make sure there's not wasteful spending and hope that you can trust that they will tell you the truth and evaluate their own. And I want to apologize for my nervousness. I'm still nervous, and I just want to thank you for the opportunity to speak here tonight. I'm very proud to be a Campbell Countyan, and I take pride in it. When somebody says, "Where are you from?" I say, "I'm from La Follette," and they go, "Oh," and I go, "Well, you know, until you've been here, you don't appreciate it," and just want to say I love it. Thank you.
Thank you, Tammy Milner, running for District 3 County Commission. We now go to Ralph Grant, County Commission 4. And Ralph, your closing thoughts and about cutting the budget.
I couldn't touch it right now because it'd be I defend anybody anyway. But what really bothers me sitting here right now looking at this room, people don't come out, and they ain't never come bold either. So if the radio station or Channel 12 would get together and give away a new Cadillac, if you vote, you get to drive your Dave out, we'd get some voters to come out. But that's the only way I can think of to do it, because nobody else would go. It just won't do it. And then if we got everybody out to vote, well, then they'd all register, then they'd know how to tax them. So I'll be it on one another. But, my name is Ralph Wynn. I live in Campbell County. I work in Campbell County. I've scratched out a living for a few years now. And some of the most beautiful things in our county is there because we didn't get the industry. The industry went down to Fort Lauderdale Lake, gone up all everywhere, everything a mess. And we get here, we got the most beautiful lake, we had the largest lake, we got the most beautiful mountains, we kept the garbage out of it, and then all that gets piled up. So let's consider more than creating some any type of job. Let's look over it for a while. And go Vols!
Thank you. Ralph Grant is running for County Commission in District 4. And Rusty Orrick is running in District 3. He's an incumbent. And Rusty, your closing thoughts and touching on the budget and cuts.
Okay. Just like the rest of them, and I've sat on the County Commission for 8 years. There's some hard choices. We've made some in the past. We did some cuts. And you have to be ready for the fallout. But sitting here tonight, one cut, and you start at home. I'll just be honest with you as a commissioner. You start at the commission. You cut the insurance out. I know it's something that's probably not going to be very, very thought of, and a lot of commissioners that's probably sitting right now probably give me that ill look and I run into them, but that's one thing that we can cut. You've got to start, if you want cuts, you've got to start at your own house. But we're just going back on the budget. I know I kind of made a mess out of it a while ago. I'm nervous just like Ms. Miller is. Not a good public speaker. My family budget, I usually base it on the year by year. With the county budget, you can't. You have to look right on down the road and keep your eyes focused. And for the future of Campbell County, you've got to look down 25 years or 30 years. Just little small decisions made year by year don't make a whole lot of worth. But, you know, that's my thought on the budget cuts. I'm Rusty Orrick. I appreciate your support. I don't know. I thought I heard somebody say something. I'm sorry. I'm Rusty Orrick. I'm one of the 3rd District County Commissioners. I'm asking for your vote. I'll be there. My record speaks for itself. I'm trying to be as honest as I can be. I'm trying to do the job. I put time and effort into it. I was taught as a young child to work hard. If Dad always said, if you want something in life, you got to put a lot into it. But he also said, don't get involved in something you can't put 100% into it. But your vote, I would be very, very appreciative for me if you'd vote for me. Keep me in mind. May God bless y'all, and thank you for your time this evening and setting this up.
Thank you, Rusty. Rusty Orrick running for re-election in District 3, County Commission. Scott Gunner is running in District 3. And Scott, closing thoughts from you, please, and a thought or two about budget cuts.
Well, as I said in my opening statement, I promise to inform myself of the issues that we're going to be facing when I get elected to the commission with y'all's help. I will work hard for you. I've lived here all my life. This is a beautiful county. We need to strengthen it by making smart, informed decisions. And that's basically what I'm running for, is my heart and soul is right here, and I want to strengthen our community with the help of your vote.
Thank you. Thank you, Scott Gunner, running for County Commission, District 3. Running for re-election in District 4 is Sue Nance. And Sue, a closing comment and touch on the budget, if you will, please.
Okay. Rusty's right. Cutting some insurance that we're presently supporting is a way to cut out some of the budget. and it should be done. We're paying insurance for commissioners, and that's they also pay a portion of it, but it's available if they want to take the insurance. We're also paying for retirees when they're in the gap between the time they retire and they start drawing Social Security. I'm not sure that's wise use of the county money, but I can think of about two or three departments that if I had a magic wand, that I'd probably cut out some things in those departments. I'm not going to name those departments because they'd probably lynch me tomorrow if I did. So, but there is some wasteful spending that could be cut, and I think we need to look at that carefully. We're going to have to look at it or either raise taxes, which I'm totally opposed to. I promise that I'll always be available to listen and try to act on any concerns you have, and that I will try my very best to keep down the spending and to increase revenue any way I see possible, and also that I will try to make Campbell County a better place to live. My name's Sue Nance. Appreciate your vote.
Thank you. Sue Nance, running in District 4 for re-election. We now go to Thomas Burge, who is also running in District 4 for County Commission. Thomas, a closing thought from you, and a word or two about the budget, please.
Touching on the budget, I cannot sit here and make an informed decision of what I would cut or what I wouldn't without looking at the books. I'm not a commissioner right now. I hope to become that, and I will do my best to make an informed decision when that time comes. But right now, it's someone's life. A number is somebody. A number is dinner, a pair of shoes for a child. You have to put that in consideration. It's not an easy decision. It's something you have to sit down and make an informed, educated decision. On the closing thoughts, I know I'm young. I'm the youngest one up here by far. I'm a Campbell County graduate. I went to LMU. I put myself through college. Education is the key. I came back to Campbell County because I wanted to give back to the county that gave so much to me. I teach school. I don't do it for the money. I do it because I want to make a difference in the future. That is why I'm here trying to make a difference in our county. I want to make this place somewhere that people will say, I went to Campbell County, and I'm proud of it. I'm from Campbell County. You should come see our county. It's great. We have lots of jobs for our kids. Our kids do well. Our families prosper. I want that to be Campbell County, not the, yeah, I went to Campbell County High School. No one knows about that. Campbell County is north of Knoxville. I want to be Campbell County. Yeah, we're Knoxville south of us. We're somebody important. We have I-75. We have CSX rail lines. We have the base for industry. We just have to take the initiative and reach it and grab. Thank you. I'm running for Campbell County Commission. My name is Thomas Burge. See Thomas Burge for a better Campbell County.
Thank you. Thomas Burge is running in District 4. Candidates, let me remind you that there's a business card on the desk near you there for Sam Smith. He's the man who's pulling all of the information together on the pre-election publication from the La Follette Press. He asked for some thoughts from you, 200 words, maybe 300, if you could email that to him at his address there by Monday. He would appreciate that. Our thanks to Gary Carter on the camera tonight, Karen Kubich with the La Follette Press, Joe King, Brent Channing, the La Follette Press, Noah Smith with WLAF and the La Follette Press, Boomer Winfrey with WLAF, and Sam, thank you. We thank the Campbell County Board of Education for allowing us to use the building tonight, and a special thanks to Principal Steve Rutherford here for allowing us to use Jacksboro Middle School as the host this evening for our second forum. Our third forum is coming up next week. We'll be at Jellicoe High School. Might be a little bit cooler there. I don't know. We will host the sheriff's candidates and the school board and county commission candidates from District 5 next Thursday, 6 p.m. at Jellicoe. Love to see you there if you want to make the trip on over. Special thanks tonight for our county commission candidates, Cliff Jennings, Tammy Milner, Ralph Grant, Rusty Warwick, Scott Gunter, Sue Nance, Thomas Burge. Let's have a nice round of applause as we leave out. Thank you.